Welcome to the fantasy audiobook. Naruto. Sky panel appears, all five Kages are shocked. People are in tears. Chapter 61. No matter how depraved Orochimaru is, he still thinks she's cute. I finally understand how the third Hokage felt at that time. As he spoke, Kakashi lifted up the forehead protector that covered his left eye. Suddenly, the Sharingan was exposed, emitting a strange glow. Hokage office. Sarutobi Hiruzen and others' eyes narrowed, especially Jiraiya, who felt particularly angry. It was really that guy who killed the third generation old man. I didn't expect that it was really Orochimaru who did it. That guy is back after all, Jiraiya said in a deep voice. If it were before, he would still feel a little unconvinced. Then, he remembered that when he was teaching Naruto how to tread water, the other party couldn't do it well. It was because he added a five-element seal to the eight seals. At that time, he suspected that the other party must have taken advantage of the Chunin exam period when Konoha was open to the outside world and sneaked into Konoha at this time. On screen, Sasuke looked at the other party's exposed Sharingan, his eyes became even colder. Sharingan, proof of the Uchiha clan. You are a lowly foreigner, don't show me your eyes. Sasuke rushed out angrily, summoning shurikens from his arms. But the target of the shuriken attack was not Kakashi, but Sakura and the other person hiding behind the bridge. Kakashi also discovered this. Escape, Earth Flow Wall. Kakashi leaned down and supported himself with his hands. Suddenly, the bridge began to tremble. A hard rock wall with a dog head painted on it rose up from the ground, blocking Kakashi behind him. Bang, bang, bang. The shuriken hit the rock wall, and Sasuke rushed towards Kakashi holding the Chidori. The latter dodged violently and finally landed steadily on the lake. Your Sharingan is good enough for borrowing, but can your Sharingan do this? Sasuke said with a disdainful smile. I'll let you see the difference between the Sharingan. Sasuke's eyes widened, revealing a pair of six-pointed star kaleidoscopes. In Kakashi's shocked eyes, a purple Susanoo condensed around Sasuke's body. The third power, half of Susanoo's body bones holding a purple bow and arrow. In the picture, Sasuke pulled the Susanoo spear and shot an arrow towards Kakashi. Kakashi looked at this scene in horror, and his Sharingan suddenly changed in this scene, it was a sickle-like kaleidoscope. Kaleidoscope, the ninja world was trembling at this scene. How could Kakashi possess the Mangekyo? Doesn't he only have the Sharingan? A foreigner can actually use a kaleidoscope. Are you kidding me? Aren't Mangekyo rare? How come Kakashi also has one? Is it a copy? Hokage's office. Kaleidoscope. It was Itachi and Sasuke, both of them looked surprised. Especially Sasuke, that look seemed to be saying, how could you, a foreigner, open the Mangekyo eyes? You know, even he, an Uchiha of orthodox bloodline, hasn't opened his Mangekyo eyes, and you, an outsider. Don't look at me like that, I'm actually shocked too. Kakashi touched his eyes, he was also shocked, he didn't even know about this. On screen, the moment after Kakashi's Mangekyo, the arrow shot by Susanoo was suddenly twisted by an unknown force, but it still splashed a large amount of water. Is that Susanoo? Kakashi asked anxiously. Sasuke looked at the other person's eyes and was also slightly surprised, I didn't expect that you, an outsider, could actually open the Mangekyo. You should really thank the Uchiha clan for its power. Sasuke, you shouldn't only have your clan members and hatred in your heart. You should take a good look at your heart. Here we go again, you should know clearly. Sasuke's face twitched, and it was a picture of Naruto and the others smiling. Laughing, everyone is laughing. Immediately afterwards, Sasuke became angry. That smile was earned with Itachi's life. They knew nothing, but they smiled so happily. Feeling Sasuke's anger, Susanoo changes again, it is the powerful Susanoo, Karasu Tengu armor form. For me now, your laughter is contempt and ridicule. I will turn all those laughters into screams and wails. Is that the power that Uchiha Itachi used before? What a terrifying majesty. Is that the power of Susanoo? I feel the trembling even through the screen. The Uchiha are all monsters. The entire ninja world witnessed this power once again and was immediately shocked. This power made them palpitate and yearn for it. At the same time, I felt more and more terrified towards that clan. The 12 young warriors of Konoha looked at this scene, all showing their fears and sighing. This kind of power was no longer something they could touch. Is this Uchiha? This kind of power really makes them feel desperate. Wow, so amazing. Naruko was stunned. Is Sasuke so powerful? Seeing Naruko's stunned expression, Sasuke hummed softly, very satisfied. I will definitely be more powerful than you, this arrogant Sasuke, in the future. Just wait for me to beat me up. Seeing Sasuke's arrogant look, Naruko was unhappy. You are such a loser. It's impossible even in 100 years. On screen, as soon as Sasuke made his bold statement, Susanoo immediately began to weaken, and finally the entire Susanoo disappeared, leaving Sasuke alone standing there. Also, the pair of kaleidoscopes also disappeared, as if they were somewhat blind. My vision is blurred. Is this what they call trying to be cool but getting bad? Sasuke is really pretentious during this period. I don't know why, but I really want to beat him up. Blind, what happened? Looking at the time when Sasuke opened the Mangekyo before, it seemed to be the same time as now. How could he become blind so quickly? Isn't this usage frequency a bit too frequent? At this moment, on the bridge, Sakura sneaks up on Sasuke with a kunai. I can't let Kakashi-sensei do everything. Just when the kunai was about to pierce Sasuke's back, it stopped in time. She still couldn't do it. Thank you, Sakura. That was when Sasuke defected. That night, Sasuke whispered behind Sakura. Obviously, I've already made up my mind. Sasuke had already reacted, turned around and grabbed Sakura's throat, snatched the kunai from her hand, and stabbed her. Sasuke, stop. Just when the kunai was about to pierce, a figure suddenly rushed in and rescued Sakura. Stop, Sasuke. Seeing Sasuke holding a kunai and stabbing at Sakura, Kakashi's face suddenly changed and he shouted anxiously. The ninja world looked at this scene and became nervous. No, why did Sakura stop at the end? It's over. Is this woman stupid? At the critical moment, a young man with yellow hair rescued Sakura in an instant, but her face was still scratched by the kunai. The young man turned his head with a glare, revealing a resolute but handsome face. His six whiskers were very noticeable. It was Uzumaki Naruto. In a flower shop in Konoha. Huh, I'm so glad Sakura is okay. Ino, who was wearing an apron, breathed a sigh of relief. Fortunately, everything was fine. The scene just now was really scary. Sakura's parents also breathed a sigh of relief and looked at Uzumaki Naruto in the picture with gratitude. Finally caught up. Speaking of which, Naruto is a frequent visitor to the Sky Curtain, right? He has always been there. Sasuke isn't it when you put it that way. He appears in all these videos. Tell me, who is stronger among them at this moment? That must be Sasuke, okay. Do you think Naruto can contend with the power of the Mangekyo? You're not in prison, that's not right, right? Doesn't Naruto have the nine tails? Hokage's office. It's me. Naruko looked at the boy in the picture with ecstasy, and then said firmly, you lecherous sage, just wait and see, I will definitely bring Sasuke back. I didn't leave. Sasuke snorted, dissatisfied. On screen. Naruto seemed very angry because of Sasuke's previous actions, and said, Sasuke, Sakura is also a member of Team 7. Sasuke looked at Naruto and showed no surprise. Instead, he sneered and said, for me, it was Team 7 before. Kakashi stood in front of the two, staring at Sasuke who looked like Shira in front of him, and said, now you should understand, Naruto, he is no longer the Sasuke of the past. Hearing this, Naruto closed his eyes, then slowly opened them. Sasuke, what's up, ninja world? No, you're changing your face too quickly, aren't you? What's going on? Sasuke would reply so kindly. Is this a mistake? It's a face-changing package, right? Kakashi. Sasuke. Sasuke. Stop acting like a teacher all the time, Kakashi. Sakura. Sasuke. Sasuke. You are really annoying. Naruto. Sasuke. Sasuke. What's the matter? Not a prisoner, but a person who can change his face. Okay. Kakashi. I'm Reza Naruto. I know, this is love. I love you. The 12 young strongmen were also somewhat skeptical. Sasuke in the picture had already reached such an extreme point, how could he speak so kindly? Naruto-kun, and Sasuke, love. Hinata felt dizzy. She couldn't even defeat a man. Hokage's office. Everyone looked at the two of them strangely. Sasuke and Naruto's faces turned green, especially the latter, who really wanted to find a hole in the ground. It was so embarrassing. On the screen, Sasuke, "I've heard the truth about Itachi from Afe. I don't know whether what he said is true or not, but I can understand what you did." Naruto and Sasuke looked at each other, and the former said slowly, "Naruto, I've said it before. You have neither parents nor brothers, so how can you possibly understand my feelings? You're an outsider, so just shut up," Sasuke said in an extremely cold tone. Outside the sky, in the Hokage's office, Naruto raised his eyebrows when he heard this, and a hint of dissatisfaction appeared on his little face. For some reason, Sasuke's words made her very sad, so she decided to ignore him for the time being. On the screen, before Naruto responded, Sakura immediately refuted him, "Do you know how Naruto feels about you? No matter what bad rumors he heard, he always treated you as a companion. Even if everyone wanted to kill you, Naruto always wanted to save you." Save me for what?" Sasuke sneered. "Revenge," Naruto started, and then with a firm look in his eyes, he said, "I will definitely save you from the swamp of revenge." In the picture, Sasuke smiled with disdain. "There is no need for this. My revenge has already begun. Just now, I finally killed one of Itachi's enemies," Sasuke said, but the sky screen changed. "This is what happened before on this bridge. Sasuke and Danzo fought on this bridge." In the picture, Danzo's arms are covered with Sharingan. Finally, he casts a seal to seal half of the bridge. "I killed a high-ranking official of Konoha here, a guy named Danzo. Ninja world. Danzo." Danzo in the Root's face turned black. "That Uchiha brat, how is that possible?" Danzo said coldly. "Who is Danzo? He was killed by the orphan of Uchiha. Are you kidding me? That kid really can't stay. It was he who arranged the Root's attack on Sasuke, but in the end no news came at all, which made him wonder whether those Root were still alive. Hokage's office. That guy's arm. Looking at the Sharingan on Danzo's arm, Sasuke and Itachi's eyes were full of coldness and murderous intent. How many Uchiha clan members did that Danzo harm? "Itachi, Sasuke, don't worry, I will give you an explanation," said the Sandame, and then his eyes also filled with coldness. This guy Danzo was becoming more and more extreme. How could such a thing happen right under his nose? Is he the Hokage, or am I the Hokage? Itachi remained silent, but Sasuke was dismissive. Danzo must die, and he must kill the other party, and no one could stop him. Danzo is dead. That's so satisfying. Well done, good job, good death. That guy Danzo, his arms are covered with Sharingan. Are you kidding? How many Uchiha clan members did that guy harm? If this doesn't happen, even I can't stand it. Five major countries. Onoki. Good thing he died. I support Danzo's death with both hands, okay. The fourth Raikage. The great Danzo was actually killed by the Uchiha orphan. Ha 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 ha, it makes people happy. I can only say that he is a waste. Mei Terumi. I really want to chop off that arm, Danzo, I look down on you. Snake Uncle pretending to be Casecage. What else can I say? Danzo. Danzo in the Root had a black face, and he looked gloomily at Sasuke's rampant smile in the picture. This kid must not be allowed to stay. Sasuke actually killed Danzo. Naruko showed a shocked expression, her eyes were full of shock, and then she whispered, "Who is Danzo?" The office was silent, "So what on earth are you shocked about?" It's not her fault that she's stupid, but her memory is poor and she vaguely knew that this person existed. That's right, that's the guy. Naruko looked at the scene that flashed across the sky and remembered that it was the guy who forced Sasuke's brother away. It turns out that the Danzo they were talking about was him. In the picture, that Danzo, Sasuke actually defeated him by himself, Kakashi said in disbelief. That was a feeling I had never had before. It was like the tainted Uchiha was purified. You can't possibly understand the feeling of Uchiha bidding farewell to this decadent ninja world. In the picture, Sasuke has already gone crazy, so crazy that he spreads his hands, wanting to release his emotions to the fullest. Then, Sasuke continued with a smile. What I did, in a sense, was also what you Konoha had hoped for a long time. As you who have always denied the Uchiha wish, I will completely delete it from your memory. Kill all of you, everything in Konoha. Cut off all ties with Konoha. This is purification. This is the true revival of Uchiha. Ninja world. He's crazy. The Uchiha second pillar has gone completely crazy. No one can help him now. The prison sentence is over. Erzu is no longer the same Erzu as before. The second pillar you are talking about is Uchiha Sasuke. Why is it so abstract? It's well packed. Big pillar Itachi, second pillar Sasuke. In the scene, Naruto and the other two were slightly shocked when they heard Sasuke's bold words. Their eyes were full of disbelief. Is this still Sasuke? His situation is now completely different from what it was back then, and even extreme to a terrifying degree. Kakashi stared at Sasuke and said, "It is hatred that has accumulated into history and created the Sasuke of today. Sasuke is a victim of this era. Whether it's Naruto or Sakura, they are more or less, but they also feel it personally." In the picture, Kakashi recalled the days of Team 7, when Naruto, Sasuke, and Sakura fought side by side. From Zabuza, to the Chunin exam, to the breakup between Naruto and Sasuke. Bang! Bang! In the scene, Naruto used the seal to create two shadow clones, but Kakashi blocked them with his hands. Kakashi said, "Leave this to me, you guys leave now. Some things must be undertaken personally by me, the teacher." Hearing Kakashi's dissuasion, Sakura became anxious and said, "But, Kakashi, leave quickly. If you stay, you will see things you don't want to see." Kakashi said in a deep voice before the other party finished speaking. Then, Kakashi stared at Sasuke, took two steps in the lake, and whispered, "The poison learned from Shizune cannot kill Sasuke. He has Orochimaru's anti-poison ability in his body. You should know. Besides, you should also be clear about your own feelings, right?" After hearing this, both of them fell silent. That's it. Kakashi killed him. This Uchiha Sasuke is so brave that he wants to destroy Konoha. What a joke. Have you guys in Konoha made any mistake? Aren't you the ones who forced this situation into this? If not you, who else shall we destroy? So funny, you Konoha villagers are so hypocritical, just sit down. Sizzle. X2. Those were Chidori and Raikiri, condensed from Sasuke and Kakashi's hands respectively, like thousands of roars. In the scene, Naruto, who was standing behind Kakashi, finally spoke with a serious expression, "Teacher Kakashi, the thing you said you didn't want to see, is killing Sasuke." Kakashi did not respond to the other party's words, but continued to urge, "Leave here quickly." But the next moment, Sasuke rushed towards the three people holding Chidori, and the murderous intent was chilling. Before Kakashi could make any move, Naruto's shadow clone hugged Kakashi from behind, stopping him from moving. Kakashi changed and asked, "Naruto." After the clone controlled Kakashi, Naruto rolled out a Rasengan at lightning speed, stepped on the water surface, and rushed towards Sasuke in front of him at a high speed. Wawa, Zizi. The whistling sound of the Rasengan is completely different from the sharp cry of the Chidori. Uzumaki Naruto and Uchiha Sasuke are approaching at a very fast speed. The special moves in the hands of both of them also move with each other, approaching each other, and the collision between Rasengan and Chidori will once again appear in front of the ninja world. Everyone in the ninja world held their breath as they watched this scene. It was not like there had never been a collision before, but every time, they kept a close watch. They also want to know, is Uzumaki Naruto's Rasengan more powerful, or is Sasuke's Chidori better? On the screen, they are all flaws. "I won't show mercy," Sasuke sneered. The two figures are approaching each other, and the moves in their hands are the same. In the lake, one side is under the shadow, the other side is under the sun. Time seemed to slow down countless times at this moment. Naruto looked at the figure that was getting bigger and bigger in front of him, and vaguely remembered that day. That was the battle in the Valley of the End. It was the same movements, same moves, same people. Under the gaze of the two stone statues, Rasengan and Chidori. And now, Sasuke, you and I. Maybe it's the other way around. The next moment, boom, Rasengan, Chidori. In the picture, the Rasengan and Chidori finally collided with each other, causing a large splash of water, and the entire lake surface was shaking violently. Under the gazes of countless people, the entire lake surface was in turmoil. This power was truly terrifying. The 12 ninja warriors of Konoha stared at the scene in a daze, feeling extremely pressured. Sasuke was strong, and that was fine, but how strong was Naruto now? They felt a little dissatisfied, but they knew in their hearts that Sasuke and Naruto in the picture were no longer their rivals. Hokage's office. Looking at the turbulent appearance of the lake, your future strength will increase terrifyingly. Kakashi exclaimed. Even he was amazed by the collision scene on the screen. This confrontation was far more intense than the previous one in the Valley of the End, even with the most common moves for both of them. It is no exaggeration to say that the strength of the two people in the picture is already very different. Is that so, Mr. Kakashi? I must be even more powerful than Sasuke. Naruko waved her little fists, her little face full of excitement. She would never lose to that idiot Sasuke. She would definitely be stronger than him in the future, 100 times stronger than him. Just you. You'd better stop daydreaming, you're the last one. Sasuke mocked mercilessly. Looking at the small interaction between Sasuke and Naruto, there were faint warm laughter in the office, and Itachi narrowed his eyes and watched this scene. Naruto-kun, thank you for making friends with Sasuke. Itachi murmured in his heart, but his eyes were unusually gentle. On the screen, as the Rasengan and Chidori collided, the entire scene slowly became blurred, and then, there was a golden and brilliant space. In this brilliant space, Naruto and Sasuke looked at each other calmly. Sasuke, you know, the people in the village used to hate me because of the 9-tailed fox in my body. I also hated the people in the village and thought about revenge. In the picture, Naruto looks at the other person and calmly tells about his past. If there is a slight deviation, I might do something terrible like you and think about destroying Konoha, Naruto muttered, describing his pain. Sasuke was unusually calm, quietly acting as a companion. Naruto-kun. Hinata looked at the sky and saw Naruto's painful expression, and her heart ached. Uruka also had the same idea, his eyes filled with tears and heartache. The entire ninja world was much quieter at this moment, listening quietly to Naruto's narration of pain in the picture. The scene changes, and along with Naruto's perspective, that is Naruto's childhood memory, emerging in the sky. Why do you still keep that thing in Konoha village? Why don't you lock him up? Why don't you think about us, Sandame-sama? Get out of here, you monster. Monsters like you are not welcome in my store. It's him. He's the one who killed. The Jinchuriki of the ninja world looked at the scene on the screen and fell silent. Obviously they are not the protagonists, but why do these scenes seem so familiar, as if they have experienced them personally? That kind of pain, that kind of being excluded, isolated, hated for no reason, that kind of suffocating coldness, the feeling of loneliness. Aren't they the same? They have done nothing, have no memory, understand nothing, and are excluded for no reason. They have all thought about whether there is any meaning in their existence. Why on earth? Why does everyone treat me like this? Why does even the homeroom teacher have this expression? I'm not a bacteria nor a nuisance, I'm Uzumaki Naruto. That was young Naruto, shouting at the villagers who were ostracizing him. He had done nothing wrong, so why were they doing this to him? What did I do wrong? What is the meaning of my existence? What do I exist for? Being excluded, isolated, hated, and treated as a monster. As a young boy, he didn't understand or comprehend. That feeling of not being needed by anyone, that feeling of suffocation, made the ninja world sigh. The cage-level masters of the 5 great nations were also silent. They all understood what had happened to the Jinchuriki, but they could not change the status quo. This child is so pitiful. It must be very difficult for him to grow up so healthy without parents, right? Woo, you Konoha are so inhuman. You force a child into this. Are you still human? I really want to hug him. It must have been hard to go there, right? It must have been very difficult and painful, right? All the tender-hearted women in the ninja world showed kindness and concern towards him. They felt sorry for this little Naruto. At the same time, he felt strongly dissatisfied with Konoha. I thought I would never have any intersection with anyone. Having said this, Naruto paused, looked at Sasuke, and said softly, until I met you and Uruka-sensei. Outside the sky, in the Hokage's office, Sasuke was startled. This sentence reminded him of what Naruto said before. Until I met you. Naruto at that time also said something like this, met me. Met me, someone like me. For some reason, the corner of his mouth slightly raised, but it was quickly hidden, but still discovered by the careful Naruko. Haha, Sasuke, did you laugh just now? Naruko asked, moving closer curiously. No, you're blushing, you must be laughing. I've already told you to stay away from me. In the picture, Naruto was walking alone by the river and met that lonely child. The two of them just glanced at each other and turned away awkwardly. The scene changes again, that is the battle against Bai. Why do you want to protect someone like me? Shut up, you loser, it's my body, I can't help it. No matter what, you have to live. Sasuke. Naruto and Sasuke looked at the scene and their expressions changed slightly. It was the battle from that day that they remembered, and the former felt a little sad at the same time. The scene returns to that brilliant space. In the picture, Naruto rubbed his head with a silly smile, showing a warm face, and said, I also know that you are always alone. Looking at your figure, I know that there are people who are like me, and I feel at ease. I carry the nine tails, and you carry the fate of the Uchiha. We carry similar things. When I saw you that day, I actually wanted to talk to you right away. I was very happy and thought you could understand my feelings. But, I still gave up. Here, Naruto paused again, his azure eyes dimmed, and he said, if you want to know why, it's because I envy you for being able to do everything. I took the liberty of treating you as my opponent. Naruto suddenly raised his head, with a kind face, and smiled, from then on, you became my target. Mingzi, who was outside, witnessed this and changed slightly. Her little face looked a little unnatural. She wasn't going to say that, was she? In front of so many people. Naruko looked at Sasuke secretly, but Sasuke ignored her and stared at the sky. He was so familiar with what Naruto said, because, he had heard it before. I had nothing, but now I have a bond with you, Sakura, in Team 7. I want to be like you, strong and handsome. Sasuke stared at the scene in a daze. The other party's words gave him a great shock. Why did he feel this way? That kind of peace of mind, that kind of warmth. I have never felt it before except with my family. The feeling of being admired. In fact, I have always been chasing you behind you. Naruko's little face became more and more unnatural, and her feet were scratching the soles of her shoes wildly. This was exposed, it was too embarrassing. You, Tianmu, stop talking. Now the whole ninja world knows about it. Naruko said angrily in her heart. In the picture, Naruto showed a brilliant smile, as bright as the sun, and said, I am so lucky to have met you in this life. Naruto was silent. Sasuke is moved. Ninja world silence. The entire ninja world fell into a brief silence after Naruto's confession. I can. I don't know why, but I'm a little envious of Sasuke, but I'm a man. Oh my god, even I was almost moved by this kind of confession. Could this Naruto be the succubus of Konoha? Konoha Flower Shop. That Naruto, looks so handsome. Ino was impressed by Naruto's handsomeness. Will Naruto become so steady when he grows up? And why, this sense of security, this warm feeling? Even the always crazy Ino was surprised by Naruto's calm side, and for some reason, he didn't wear a forehead protector. It seems, quite handsome. Could it be that the other person is a hidden handsome guy? It's not her fault, but Naruto in the picture is just too shocking. Not to mention her, even countless girls were deeply moved by Naruto's steady, handsome, confession. Hyuga Clan. Naruto. Naruto-kun, so handsome. Little Hinata felt like she was going to dizzy. The Naruto in the picture was so handsome and reliable, although he is still reliable now. Does this guy like men? Hinata Hanabi looked at Naruto in the picture with a strange look. He increasingly felt that the relationship between Naruto and Sasuke was special. On screen, Sasuke was not moved by Naruto's confession. His face remained cold, as if everyone owed him 2 million. Naruto, no matter what you say, I won't change. Whether it's you or those guys in the village, I will kill them all without leaving a single one alive. Hearing this, Naruto's smile turned bitter, and he said, I say, is this really the only way to go? Sasuke said coldly, yes. The choice you can make now is either to kill me and become a hero of Konoha, or to be killed by me and become a stray dog. Naruto slowly opened his narrowed eyes, revealing a determined look, and said, Sasuke, I don't think so. I will neither be a stray dog nor a hero who kills you. I am neither. I. Then, this brilliant space gradually became blurred. Boom. Outside, the Rasengan and the Chidori were still entangled, neither of them giving in, and finally with a bang, both of them were blown away. Naruto. Kakashi saw this and instantly broke free from his restraints, dodged in an instant, and caught Naruto steadily. And at the moment when Sasuke was about to sink into the rock wall, a layer of white zetsu spread out from his body, offsetting most of the impact. Now, I understand everything. Naruto looked at Sasuke and said slowly. I have a question, why did Sasuke listen to Naruto's long speech so calmly? This is love. 6. If it were me, I would probably fall for this confession. Naruto and Sasuke hold the banner, okay. I'll give 500 to them when they get married. Gaara narrowed his eyes. Hokage's office. Sasuke, are you still leaving? Naruko turned her head, looked at Sasuke and asked. Upon hearing this, everyone around immediately turned their eyes to the other party, wanting to hear the other party's answer. Sasuke, on the other hand, had no expression on his face. He seemed to be in deep thought, sometimes turning around, sometimes turning cold. On the screen, beside Sasuke, there was a whirlpool, followed by a figure in a dark cloud robe with a mask. It was the masked man. Sasuke, it's time to go back, said the masked man. Masked man. In the Hokage's office, the few people looking at the figure narrowed their eyes. They were particularly wary of the former. Even Uchiha Itachi looked at him solemnly. So far, he had very little information about the masked man. Itachi, do you know any information about this masked man? Hiruzen asked bluntly. Hearing this, Itachi nodded and told the other party everything he knew, including the fact that the other party had that abnormal ability to become a hollow. When they learned that 12 years ago, it was the masked man who controlled the Nine Tails and invaded Konoha, they were extremely shocked. The strength of this masked man is definitely not that of an ordinary person. Kakashi murmured, his expression particularly solemn. The nine-tailed fox, can that kind of being really be controlled? Itachi was speechless, because he remembered the reward from Tianmu before. It was more like a message than a reward. The Fourth Ninja World War, I hereby declare war. Itachi could never forget that voice. It was the voice of the masked man during the Fourth Shinobi World War. It's this masked man again. I can tell from the first glance that he's not a good person. I always feel that something big might have happened before in the picture. On the screen, Nine Tails. It seems like you can't help but fight as soon as you meet. To hunt the Nine Tails, I have prepared a bigger stage for you. Now leave first. The masked man looked at Uzumaki Naruto and said softly. At this time, Naruto walked on the lake surface and slowly walked towards Sasuke. Naruto. And Naruto just said calmly. Don't worry, Teacher Kakashi, I just have something to say to Sasuke. In the picture, Naruto stopped in the middle of the lake and looked at Sasuke again. Sasuke, do you still remember what you said to me once in the Valley of the End? Those words about a first-rate ninja. In the picture, Naruto said to Sasuke, and it was a picture that flashed in the latter's mind. If they are both first-rate ninjas, they can understand each other's thoughts just by fighting each other. You are too naive, Naruto. How about it? You can understand my true thoughts deep down in my heart. In the picture, Naruto and Sasuke are looking at each other. Through direct combat, we now understand each other a lot, which shows that we have become first-class ninjas. Whether it's you or me. Sasuke, do you understand my true thoughts deep in my heart? In the picture, Naruto pointed to the position of his heart and said slowly. Sasuke in the picture was a little upset when he heard this, and then Naruto said solemnly, Sasuke, you also predicted it, right? If you and I fight, we'll both die. Outside the sky, Konoha Village. The 12 little strong men looked at the steady appearance of Naruto in the picture and seemed extremely shocked. Is this still the same Naruto? His words and actions all exuded an air of reliability, and his steady appearance made them all feel at ease. This, is it still the last one, the stupid Naruto? Is this guy, really Naruto? Ino and Sakura were very shocked. Well, that stupid Naruto, could he be so reliable one day in the future? Naruto-kun is so handsome. I'm going to faint. Hinata's little face was rosy, very cute, and her eyes were full of Naruto's figure. If you want to attack Konoha, then I will have no choice but to fight you. Save all your hatred for then. Then vent it on me. I am the only one who can bear your hatred. This mission can only be accomplished by me. When the time comes, I will bear your hatred and die with you." The entire ninja world was silent after hearing what Naruto said. They were shocked by Naruto's actions. They also knew how strong Sasuke's hatred for Konoha was. This guy Naruto actually wants to bear everything and carry all Sasuke's hatred on himself. Transfer Konoha's hatred to yourself. In the Hokage's office, there was a brief silence. Naruto-kun, thank you for being friends with Sasuke. Itachi smiled harmoniously at Naruto. He was very grateful to the other party that when Sasuke fell into darkness, there were still companions who thought about him and wanted to pull him out of the darkness. Looking at the other person's kind smile, Mingzi touched his head and chuckled, looking like a skinny and cute fox, even adorable. But Sasuke snorted awkwardly, feeling a little unhappy. Long silence. Sasuke in the picture finally couldn't help but speak, and said slowly, "What's going on, Naruto?" Then, Sasuke began to get excited, his voice became fierce, and he roared, "What's wrong with you? Why are you so obsessed with me?" "Because we are friends." Sasuke was stunned, and the ninja world was also stunned. All the ninjas, both inside and outside the sky, were stunned. "What's going on? This Naruto is really, I'm going to cry to death. Is it necessary to be so good-tempered? Everyone is going to kill him. My friend, I'm going to cry to death. Is he really a Jinchuriki? Is this guy really a ninja? If they weren't both men, I would have really thought they were in that kind of relationship. I'll kowtow first as a sign of respect. I fully support their marriage. It's so hard to choose. So who is the top and who is the bottom? Ridiculous." The ninja world was shocked. In this world full of killing, is there really such a person? Was it a blessing or a misfortune for him to be born in such a ninja world? The villagers of Konoha were stunned by Naruto's words. They were speechless. They could clearly see the hatred that Sasuke had for Konoha, but the one who stood up to protect them was this child known as the Demon Fox. For a moment, they found it hard to accept it. At this moment, the hatred they had for the fox demon lessened a lot. "There is a little more recognition in my heart for the other person." Those villagers who are more rational have started to think about it. They know about the changes that Naruto has undergone over the years. Moreover, since the appearance of the Sky Curtain, more and more things about Naruto are known. Naruto, a kind child, even too kind. Even though he was ostracized by them, he could live like this. It's incredible. What should I do? What should I do? I think I've fallen in love with Naruto. Ino held up her blushing face. Naruto's steady demeanor really added a lot of points to her. Besides, the other party took off the forehead protector that sealed his appearance, coupled with that brilliant smile. Really, really, so cool. But when she thought about Naruto now, she sighed. There was no comparison at all. Naruto, at Sakura's home, Sakura looked at the scene on the screen and was so moved that she almost cried. It was great. Even if Sasuke defected, there was still Naruto, right? "This is youth, Teacher Kai," Xiao Li shouted excitedly. Might Guy hugged the other person excitedly, and in the sunlight, the two looked like a father and son. "Li, this is youth. From now on, run around Konoha 10 times while standing upside down." "Yes, Teacher Kai." As they spoke, the two of them suddenly supported themselves on the ground with their palms and turned towards Konoha at a rapid speed. "Hey, hey, hey, Li, you've just healed from your injury, can you please stop being so self-indulgent?" "And Teacher Guy," Tenten and Ningji said speechlessly. "Hyuga clan." Hinata looked at Naruto, her eyes full of longing. She always liked Naruto like this. She thought with a blushing face, while Hanabi looked helpless and became more and more jealous of Naruto. Hokage's office. "Friend," Sasuke stared at the sky with a dull look on his face. "Are he and Naruto friends?" He grabbed the clothes on his chest. For some reason, he felt extremely relieved. Sarutobi Hiruzen looked at the sky with an envious smile, thinking, "Minato, Naruto has also become an excellent ninja, is this what you want to see?" Jiraiya, on the other hand, smiled warmly and ruffled Naruko's hair in front of him. "Maybe he can really become Hokage," Kakashi murmured. On screen, the wind blew up the hair of both of them. We want to understand each other, but we can't do it in the usual way. I understood it when we first met. Naruto stretched out his fist, smiled warmly, and said, "Isn't it right to use fists to understand each other? Because we are all first-class ninjas. Mutual understanding. Your hatred, just like I changed after meeting Uruka sensei. I am the same." In the scene, Naruto suddenly smiled and said, "I haven't given up yet. I will never give up on bringing you back to Konoha." Sasuke stared at Naruto, his lips pursed unconsciously. He didn't understand why this guy was so persistent. The entire ninja world was silent. Naruto is a kind-hearted child. It's incredible, considering he has a past like that. I now understand what Mr. Chiyo said. Maybe he can really. It's Uruka again. I'm crying my ass off. You guys in Konoha should really thank him. Most residents of the ninja world have developed a favorable impression of Naruto. Konoha Ninja School. In the office, Uruka pursed his lips, his face full of excitement and heartache. On screen. Then, Naruto waved his hand and smiled, narrowing his eyes, and said, "But I won't keep nagging anymore. Really, I'm not good at preaching, but one day I started preaching. Haha." Naruto touched his head, his eyes a little evasive, and said, "If in the end, we are all dead, we are no longer Uchiha, nor are we the Nine Tails Jinchuriki. We don't have to bear anything, and we can understand each other in that world." In the Hokage's office, Sasuke stared blankly at the image on the screen. The figure was bright and warm, as if trying to pry open a crack in his closed heart. "Naruto, you," Sasuke said in a daze, looking at Naruto in front of him. Naruko couldn't help blushing and defended herself. "No, no such thing will happen, okay? We won't die." At the end of her words, Naruko puffed her head firmly, hugged her little chest, and said angrily, "They won't die, definitely not, absolutely not." Seeing this, Sasuke's heart softened, but he still said hard, "You, big idiot." In Konoha Village, the Keisuke's accommodation. Gaara stared at the sky in a daze, his brows slightly frowned. For some reason, he felt inexplicably uncomfortable, as if he was still jealous. HMPH. Gaara snorted coldly. The sand in the gourd became a little restless because of Gaara's emotions, as if it would break out at any time. No way, no way. Could it be that Gaara really? Temari and Konkoro looked at each other, and both could see shock in each other's eyes. "Well, sister, I remember that boy seemed to have turned into a girl. How about we?" Konkoro murmured to Temari in a low voice. "Let Gaara propose marriage," Temari said in shock. "The other party is a man. But isn't she a woman now?" Konkoro asked strangely. Hearing this, Temari fell into deep thought and asked, "But you also know that his punishment seems to last only 3 days. Don't we have the sky curtain? The sky curtain is so powerful, who knows if Naruto's term will become permanent in the future?" Konkoro grinned, quite strangely. "That's true, but this matter should be left to Gaara," Temari said. "Ninja world, I can. I agree to their marriage. When will it start? Let's pick a good day. Like now, you are devils, right? They are men. Aren't your ideas a little too perverted? I remember Naruto seemed to become Naruko, right? A man and a woman are here, aren't they? What do you want to do to Goddess Naruko? I tell you, Naruko is our faith. If you want to do anything to her, there is no way." "Oh, Naruko, my Naruko. What is Sasuke? He wants to marry Naruko. Let's see if our Naruko guards agree to it." The entire ninja world went crazy. Sasuke's face was dark, Gaara was angry, Naruto was stunned. On screen, Sasuke said coldly, "I will not change my mind. I will destroy Konoha, and the only one who will die is you. We must die together, Sasuke." Hearing this, Sasuke forced a casual smile from his cold expression and said, "All right, then I'll kill you first." "Naruto." Naruto said calmly, "Is it because I haven't received your approval yet?" "That's enough, Naruto. Leave Sasuke to me. You still have your dream of becoming Hokage to fulfill. You don't have to die with Sasuke," Kakashi said in a deep voice. "How can someone who can't even save a companion be considered a Hokage?" "Sasuke, leave it to me." In the picture, Naruto is extremely steady, staring at the ladder, and speaking in a deep voice. At last, it was a cave, Uchiha Sasuke and the masked man were walking forward. I want Itachi's eyes, Sasuke said. I finally figured it out, but it was so sudden. What made you change your mind? The masked man said. I want to defeat Naruto and then deny everything about him, that's all. Elder brother, I will destroy Konoha. Finish. As the curtain fell, countless people in the ninja world looked unsatisfied. They witnessed Naruto and Sasuke, Naruto's obsession with Sasuke, and Sasuke's hatred for Konoha. In the Hokage's office, I swear, I will bring Sasuke back. Naruko's little face was full of excitement. He had decided that he would bring Sasuke back. I'm not leaving, you big idiot. Sasuke said speechlessly. Ding. Congratulations to Uzumaki Naruto for answering correctly after the time limit. Award. Bang. Bang. At this moment, the entire office floor began to tremble, and then, two dark wooden coffins slowly emerged from the floor amid their shock. This. Is this a ghost? Naruto quickly hid behind Sasuke. You know, she is most afraid of ghosts and monsters. Then, Naruko carefully poked her head out from behind Sasuke, looking at him in confusion and fear. What kind of reward is this? They looked at the two wooden coffins and felt strange. Then, the wooden coffin began to tremble, and when the coffin mouth opened, two beautiful and slender figures appeared in the wooden coffin. One is pure black, the other is a striking red. Mom, Mom, Sasuke and Itachi looked at the black-haired figure, their whole bodies were stunned, with an expression of disbelief. The figure in the wooden coffin was none other than Uchiha Sasuke and Itachi's biological mother, Uchiha Makoto. Makoto seemed to have heard a familiar voice, and she opened her eyes that had been closed for years with difficulty. When she opened her eyes, she saw several familiar figures. Especially those two. When Itachi saw the other party open his eyes, he turned around abruptly and pulled up his cloud robe, as if he didn't want to see it. Mother. The next moment, Sasuke pounced forward, causing Naruko, who was hiding behind the former, to almost fall. Sasuke had lost his former coldness and threw himself into Makoto's arms. Makoto also reacted and felt the boy in her arms. Her heart gradually softened. Sasuke. Makoto's voice seemed to contain a myriad of tenderness, which gradually comforted Sasuke, and the tears in the corners of his eyes slowly slid down. You've grown up so much now. These years must have been very difficult. Makoto looked at Sasuke, who was no longer the little kid he used to be, and felt more and more distressed. They couldn't imagine what the other person's life would be like during their absence. No, Sasuke shook his head vigorously. Sasuke had so many things he wanted to tell the other person, but in the end, it turned into silent crying. It is hard to imagine that under that cold appearance, when this emotion is released, Sasuke will show his truest side. It was also the side he least wanted to show, the weak side. Makoto, who was concerned about Sasuke, also noticed Itachi's presence. She looked up and saw a figure with his back to them. She was too familiar with that thin figure. Itachi, turn around. Uchiha Itachi trembled, but remained indifferent. He didn't dare, and he didn't deserve it. 1 against 7, turn around and look at me. Misaka said in a serious tone. The latter then turned around, but kept his head down, as if he was too embarrassed to face the other party. Mother. Itachi lowered his head, he faced the other party in silence. He had persecuted the Uchiha clan, slaughtered his own people, and done such things. He was a sinner of the Uchiha clan. He no longer has the face to face his parents, nor does he have the face to face his clan members. Makoto bit her red lips, and the next moment, she reached out with her jade hand and pulled Itachi into her mother's arms. You kids, you two kids, really make me worried. Makoto said hoarsely, her eyes red and wet with tears. Hearing this, Itachi finally couldn't hold it back anymore, tears streaming down his face. I'm sorry, Mom, I'm sorry. Itachi, who had always been strong, was finally humiliated at this moment. He shed helpless tears and kept repeating one sentence. Mingzi stared at the three of them in a daze, her eyes full of longing and ignorance. She bit her red lips lightly with her pearly teeth, full of envy. She was happy that Sasuke could see his mother, but she couldn't shrink the envy in her eyes. No one knew how she felt at the moment. Boom! At this moment, the red-haired woman beside her suddenly opened her dark eyes, and a vast chakra swept out, and the floor began to crack. Exclamation mark! Exclamation mark! That is the sealed space inside Naruko's body. Kyuubi shuddered, his hair standing on end, and he immediately felt a familiar scent and felt his heart palpitate. That's Mito's chakra, Kyuubi said in shock. How did that woman come back to life? It murmured in confusion, but its heart became increasingly gloomy. Now that the woman was resurrected, it would probably be even more difficult for it to break the seal. Uzumaki Mito, the eldest princess of the Uzumaki clan, had experienced the clan's perverted sealing techniques. Until now, he still felt nervous towards her. It made her recall the fox life experience that she didn't want to recall. This woman really deserves to die. Tenmu, Madara, Hashirama, Mito, Kushina, humans. The nine-tailed fox roared wildly in the sealed space, and the overwhelming hatred swept across the surrounding water. When I get out, I, nine-tailed fox, will never let you go. Feeling this powerful chakra aura, everyone was suddenly shocked, especially the Sandame, who felt like crying for a moment. Because that is Uzumaki Mito, the woman of Senju Hashirama. Even Kakashi and Jiraiya showed expressions of shock and respect. Only Naruko stared at the former blankly, and suddenly felt a strange feeling filling her heart, and the chakra made her feel warm. That chakra, fiery yet warm, huge yet gentle, is like this to her. She took two steps forward blankly, and Mito opened his eyes and looked at the little girl. Are you the mother? Naruko said weakly. Hearing this, Mito frowned slightly, raised his hand gently, and then hit the other person's head hard. Naruko immediately covered her head and screamed in pain. It hurts so much, it's so big. Kid, don't talk nonsense, Mito said. Hearing this, Naruko's expression was a little gloomy. Isn't it? Then why is the person in the coffin Sasuke's mother? Lord Mito, is that you? Sarutobi Hiruzen said in a trembling voice. You are a monkey. Why are you so old? Mito was shocked when he saw the old appearance of Sarutobi Hiruzen. After all, he was relatively young back then. Now, in the blink of an eye, he has become so old. For the dead, there is no concept of time. What exactly happened in these years? Mito asked with a frown. Hearing this, Sarutobi Hiruzen told him everything that had happened over the years. The changes over the years had slightly altered her, and she relaxed for a moment before she looked at Naruko again, softening instantly. The reason why she was able to be resurrected and even become so young was ultimately because of this child of the Uzumaki clan. And that familiar chakra scent. Is it Kushina's child? She murmured, her eyes becoming increasingly gentle, and she gently called Naruko over. Child, come here. Hearing this, the latter shrank his head and showed a frightened expression towards Jiraiya and Kakashi. The two had no choice but to push Naruko over, and immediately the latter's frightened little body was shaking, and she looked like she wanted to cry. Looking at the other person's nervous look, Mito felt more and more distressed, and then his eyes focused, looking through the other person's body, and saw the seal. Eight seals, nine-tailed fox, she murmured in her heart, then showed a caring look and asked, what's its name? Naruto, Naruto. The latter was very embarrassed, but was afraid of the other party's power, so he had to speak weakly. Naruto, should she be called Naruko? Mito asked curiously. The other party was obviously a girl, why should she be given a boy's name? Could it be Kushina? Indeed, that little girl's personality seems to be like this. My name is not Naruko, my name is Naruto, Uzumaki Naruto, a man who aspires to become Hokage. Naruko said loudly. These guys all like to call him Mingzi, which makes him annoyed. But he is a serious boy, not a girl. Also, those guys in Tianmu kept calling him Naruko, which was disgusting. He is not Naruko, but Naruto, Uzumaki Naruto. Boy, boy, Mito's face froze, as if he was a little incredulous. He rubbed his eyes and looked again, and the other person was indeed a girl. How could it be a boy? Could it be that he was spoiled by Kushina? But when I think about it, it seems unlikely. Although Kushina is a little lively and active, it shouldn't be possible for a girl to develop a boyish personality, right? She took another serious look at the other person's body and found that it was indeed a serious girl. She immediately felt even more strange. The other person's body was quite prominent and her body was quite flexible. How could he be so cute? He could be a boy. Let me explain. Kakashi stepped forward and briefly explained how Naruto turned into a girl. Hearing this, Mito was shocked at first, then nodded. Makoto, who was standing by, was also shocked when she heard this. She never expected that there could be such a magical thing that could fundamentally change a boy into a girl. It was incredible. This kind of thing is simply unheard of. I told you I'm a boy, but you still don't believe it. Mingzi shrugged her shoulders, puffed out her chest, and snorted. Kawaii. Mito and Makoto looked at each other's tsunere little behavior and showed their love for it. It was so cute. The two women were rubbing Naruko's pretty and delicate little face. After a while, Naruko's face was almost deformed by the rubbing, and it looked puffy and cute. Don't pinch me anymore. Naruto was so angry that she couldn't say anything. She could only look at Kakashi and the others with grievance. The latter simply showed a helpless expression. You are also a child of the Uzumaki clan. With me here, no one can bully you anymore. Mito pinched Naruko's face and said softly. She could see what kind of life Naruko had been living over the years, and she also vaguely guessed that the other party's parents, Kushina, might have met with an accident. But these are just guesses, and we can only wait for the monkey to explain it himself. Hearing this, Naruko's heart softened slightly, but she still said stubbornly, who can bully me? I want to be Hokage and get the recognition of the villagers. How can I be bullied? It's not that you have to become Hokage to be recognized, but only those who are recognized can become Hokage. Itachi said at this time. Is that so? Hearing this, Mingzi was slightly surprised. Is this the case? She immediately fell into a state of thinking. Naruto. You look so much like your mother. Makoto smiled softly as she stroked Naruto's little face. Hearing this, Mingzi frowned slightly, looking a little confused. She looks a lot like her mother. Mom, what kind of person is Mom? Sasuke's mother, have you met my parents? Naruko stared at her, a little anxious. But just when the other party was about to speak, he suddenly felt a chill. It was coming from Sarutobi Hiruzen, and he immediately restrained himself a lot. Yes, you look a lot like your mother, including your personality, but you inherited your hair color from your father, Makoto said softly. Dad, Mom, Naruko murmured, feeling warm inside, as if it was the first time she heard these things. What kind of people are they? Why did they leave me again? Mingzi seemed to be crying. The third generation grandfather said that they were dead, but why did he leave her alone? Why let her face these unfair treatments? Why not be there when I need you? That's not true. They didn't abandon Naruto. They are always watching you. They are here, looking at me. Naruko said dully. Yes, they have been watching Naruto all the time, always and always. Makoto said. Sasuke's mother, then tell me, who are they? Naruko asked with hope in her eyes. I can't tell you this either. Makoto was in a dilemma for a moment. She glanced at the Sandai and said bitterly, but they loved you. Even before they left, they always loved you deeply. They have always loved me deeply. Mingzi was a little dazed. Why did she feel this way? It was just an ordinary sentence, but why did she feel her whole body was filled with strength? This feeling, this peace of mind, this infatuation, this feeling that makes her want to continue like this forever, so happy. Naruto smiled happily. His bright smile was like a little sun. Mito and the others who were watching this scene all smiled warmly. Erzu looked at this scene and raised the corner of his mouth. This is the last one. Idiot, the last one. Ah, Sasuke, I heard you, you scolded me again. I do not have, you have it, I heard it all, and you're still being stubborn. Looking at the inexplicable interaction between Naruto and Sasuke, everyone burst into laughter. Makoto's eyes became more gentle. Before she died, she was afraid that Sasuke couldn't live well alone, but now. Looking at each other, thank you, Naruto-kun, thank you for being Sasuke's friend. And I'm very sorry that I, as your mother's best friend, can't take care of you for some reason. The Uchiha clan, after the Nine-Tailed Rebellion. Naruko and Sasuke left the Hokage's office, and the next moment, Mito's expression suddenly changed, becoming gloomy, and he stared at Hiruzen. Monkey, you have to give me an explanation. She said coldly. Seeing this, Hiruzen smiled bitterly and told everything that had happened over the years without hiding anything, even the things about Naruto's parents and the demon fox. The Uchiha clan's affairs. Danzo's affairs. After hearing this, Mito became even colder, and the chakra aura was raging in the office. They were all shocked by the amount of chakra. Even the current Naruko, whose level had been improved tenfold by the Sky Curtain reward, was still far from Mito's level. This is the pure eldest princess of the Uzumaki clan. Monkey, you disappoint me so much. Mito looked disappointed. He saw the monkey doing things so fiercely back then, but now he is like this. Hiruzen could only smile bitterly. Kakashi felt this huge amount of chakra, and the envy in the corners of his eyes almost moved out of the screen. This amount of chakra was really enviable. Outside the Hokage building, Naruko looked at the bright sky. Well, the sun was about to set, so it wasn't very bright. Finally we're out. I was almost bored inside. Naruko kept complaining, holding the back of her head, her two pigtails still swaying in the air. In this scene, as Sasuke became more and more weird, the other party seemed to be becoming more and more familiar. Naruto and Sasuke walked out of the Hokage's office building with their backs to each other and just happened to see Rock Lee in his class. As for Xiao Li and Might Guy, at this moment, they were walking upside down with their hands on the ground, muttering words of youth and passion. Its thick eyebrows and the others. Mingzi looked at them and said with a slight surprise. Sasuke also looked at the other party curiously, but his expression was still cold. I say, Mr. Li, Mr. Kai, can you please restrain yourself here? This is the Hokage's office building. Tiantian said helplessly, holding his forehead. Hey, Mingzi, who was outside the office building, saw them and immediately waved her arms high and called out to them. That is, at the call, they turned their heads and saw Naruko and Sasuke standing outside the Hokage's office building. Suddenly, Tenten and Neji looked strange. That's, Naruto, Xiao Li turned over and moved closer, staring at Naruto with his thick eyebrows and big eyes, then stepped back. Naruto-kun has really turned into a girl. Xiao Li looked horrified. Hearing this, Mingzi felt like crying but had no tears. That's too much. Am I not even as good as a fake girl? Tiantian looked at the other person's heaving chest, then looked at her own flat chest, and suddenly her eyes were filled with envy. Does it have to be so majestic? I'm envious, really. Naruto, thank you for curing Li. Might Guy looked at Naruto and hugged her excitedly, his eyes filled with tears of excitement. When he learned that Rock Lee had recovered, he was so excited. He now liked Naruto even more because he saved his subordinates. Hurry up and let me go. Your tears are about to fall on my clothes. Naruto wanted to break free from the other man's arms, but she was tied up tightly and wouldn't get out of the way no matter what. If this continues, she will be suffocated. Hey, Teacher Kai, if you continue like this, Naruto will be strangled to death. Tiantian hurried forward to rescue him. Hearing this, Might Guy then let go of the ladder, and Sasuke immediately took action, pulling Naruko behind him and away from them. Naruto-kun really turned into a girl, how magical. Xiao Li's eyes were full of shock, is it so magical? Neji stared at the other person with a calm but blank expression. Although he didn't communicate much with the other person, he got to know this person better after the screen appeared after the sky curtain appeared. Although he was destined to be the nine-tailed fox, he never gave in to fate. Why, wasn't fate already predetermined? Why work so hard? In Neji's eyes, a genius is a genius, and a loser is a loser, and they will never achieve anything in their lifetime. In a trance, he remembered Naruto's oath during the Chunin exam. I will definitely defeat you. It was stained with Hinata's blood, and the boy challenged him with determination and without a trace of fear. At that time, he just thought it was all fun. But now, he has different ideas. Perhaps, destiny can really be changed. Can destiny be changed? He didn't know, but he wanted to give it a try, to fight against fate to the end with his own efforts. This little episode passed quickly, and then Naruko invited the other party to have dinner together. Naruko and the others were walking on the streets of Konoha. It was Naruko who started it, because she was hungry and wanted to eat ramen. It just so happened that when she left the office, Kakashi gave Naruko a lot of money for some unknown reason. It felt like a month was too long to use up all the time, probably because I had to compensate for not teaching Naruko ninjutsu. Ramen. Mingzi was obviously very happy and did not become anxious about becoming a girl. After all, As someone who could develop excellent seduction techniques, she was very open-minded about these things. It's only 3 days anyway, and it will be back to normal in 3 days. Is ramen all you have in your mind? Sasuke complained, his hands in his pockets. What do you know? Ramen is the most delicious thing in the world. Naruko showed a little expression of mild anger, which was very cute. The sunset gradually passed and the night came. The streets were full of lights and people, and were quite lively, but there were always some eyes staring at Naruko and Sasuke with hatred. It's them, and that Uchiha brat. Let me tell you, they are. But all of these were ignored by the two. The former was purely out of habit, while the latter didn't care. Their expressions seemed to say, if you want to hate me, then hate me. I still hate you guys. On the other side, I say, sister, what's so interesting about this market? Konkoro said helplessly. Tamari has been to this market 3 times, right? So far, she hasn't bought anything she's satisfied with. It's true, shopping with girls is really annoying. That was Gaara's team from Sunagakure. The three of them were strolling around Konoha village. Interestingly, Gaara also came today. He wanted to take a look at that guy's Konoha. The guy he was talking about was naturally Naruko. Gaara, the person you want to see is there. Tamari stopped in front and looked at Naruko and the others who were very close in front of her, and said. Hearing this, Gaara was startled, his eyes suddenly changed. Why, this feeling, this restlessness, this feeling as if he didn't have the courage to face it. Tamari and Konkoro were very shocked by this scene. Gaara actually showed an uneasy expression. It really shocked them for 100 years, right? You know, Gaara never showed this kind of expression before, is it because of that Naruto? As Naruko and the others moved forward, the crowds around the streets became denser. Even on one street, in the crowded crowd, even Naruko and the others would find it difficult to spot them if they didn't look carefully. Passing by, the figures of Naruko and others just passed each other quietly. Suddenly, Gaara's face turned pale and his fists clenched tighter. You are, Gaara Daddy Wow. Just then, a moving voice came from the front, and Naruko and others stopped in front of them. It was Naruko who spoke. She had spotted them when they passed each other before, and strangely enough, even Naruto didn't know why she called them. Hearing this voice, Gaara turned around suddenly and looked at them. He said it was them, but his eyes were only looking at Naruko. Suddenly, Sasuke and the others became serious. The former took the lead and protected Naruko behind him. Sasuke asked, what do you want to do? Gaara is not a kind person, and they don't think that he will change completely because of a sky screen video. Chapter 71. What do you want to do? Sasuke's cold voice lingered in the area, but was quickly drowned out in the crowded streets. Gaara ignored the other party and looked directly at Naruko, wanting to speak but not knowing how to start, and saw Tamari and Konkoro behind him looking anxious. Come on, say it. After a long silence, Gaara finally spoke. Uzumaki Naruto. What is love to you? Hearing this, Mingzi was slightly stunned, and after a brief silence, she suddenly looked up, showing a signature smile, and said, I don't know what love is, but I know, it was them, who pulled me out of the abyss of loneliness because they recognized my existence. Because of them, I don't feel lonely during those lonely years, because they changed me. Naruko's voice was filled with determination, causing Sasuke and the others to startle slightly before they grinned. Because of them, I feel warm, because they recognize me. You're a huge idiot, Sasuke smiled, but because of his cold nature, he quickly covered it up. Is this love? He murmured, lost in thought, and then he remembered the scene in the previous video. The pain of being alone is not just ordinary pain. I don't know why, but I can deeply understand your feelings. If you hadn't put that monster into Gaara, this wouldn't have happened. What does Gaara himself think? Have you ever asked him how he feels? That was the boy in the video, crying for him, for his enemy, questioning them, and venting about the injustice of the Jinchuriki. Both have similar pasts, but lead different lives, and both know the pain of loneliness. Can I get that kind of thing? Gaara asked with hopeful eyes, as if he was asking Naruko. Yes, you can do it, said Uzumaki Naruko with a warm smile. Really, can I? He murmured, as if he was a little unwilling to believe it. Someone like me, can someone like me really have it, have love? That kind of thing that makes him feel warm and happy. Can I really, really? Hearing this, Uzumaki Naruko frowned, then took a step and came to Gaara. It was a slender hand, slowly raised, and in Gaara's shocked eyes, it stopped in front of his eyes. Gaara looked up in surprise, and saw that it was like a small sun, shining on him. It was a silly, naive smile. There's no such thing as yes or no. My name is Uzumaki Naruto, and I'm a man who aspires to surpass all the previous Hokage. Hearing this, Gaara was stunned. The seed in his heart seemed to be about to sprout, but it did not move because he was afraid. He was a little afraid. Her smile is so cute, like a little sun, so warm. If I could. If you don't mind, then I'll be your first friend. But don't think about my companions, otherwise I will still teach you a lesson. Mingzi smiled and said like a big sister. Naruto, looking at Naruto's actions, Shaoli and others were stunned, except Sasuke, whose face was unusually dark. Gaara stared at Naruko closely, looking at this smile, it was like a ray of light shining into his heart, and the seed finally began to sprout. Time passes slowly, there is no sound at this moment. Gaara tried to raise his hand, but couldn't move it. He seemed to be afraid, expectant, helpless. He wanted to lift it up, but at this moment he found that his palm was like a mountain, unable to move, only trembling. He was anxious, he wanted to move, he wanted to get it all. As long as they could hold each other. As long as. His palms were shaking, and he couldn't stretch them out. Gaara's face turned pale, snapped, but at this moment, it was Naruko's slender hand that directly grasped Gaara's trembling palm. From now on, we'll just be friends. Gaara was stunned. Her hand was so small, so warm, and so powerful. Friend. Is this the feeling of being cared for, and owned? Gradually, Gaara finally opened his heart. It was a smile that slowly rose from the corner of his mouth, like a spring breeze. Good friend. Gaara opened his heart, smiled easily and happily, and he also had friends. In the wide but crowded street, the two smiled at each other. Quote dot 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 quote. Sasuke. For some reason, this scene made Sasuke extremely angry, and he even had the urge to hit someone. Temari and Konkoro smiled like old fathers and looked at the scene with great satisfaction. I agree to this marriage. They thought to themselves. Sasuke narrowed his eyes and looked at their clenched hands. His dark eyeballs gradually lit up with a hint of red light. That's the Sharingan. For some reason, he felt inexplicably irritated, especially when he saw the interaction between Naruko and Gaara, he even had the urge to kill Gaara. Hey, we're going to eat Ichiraku ramen, why don't we go together? Naruko invited with a smile. Today is a great day, I made a new friend. She really likes this canopy. Even though it turns her into a female, it doesn't stop Naruko from liking it. Okay, I can do whatever you say. Gaara smiled warmly. Now in his eyes, there was only Naruko and the others. Huh, you mean Konkoro and Temari? I guess so. He didn't know why, but looking at Mingzi's giggling face, he felt that all the precious things in the world were not as valuable as her. As this, the feeling of friends. Gaara thought to himself, and suddenly felt that he was the happiest person in the world. Sasuke, I don't know why, but he has a sense of deja vu. No, how long are you two going to hold on? Can you please let go right now? But these were all Sasuke's inner thoughts, and he didn't say them out loud. He knew the current atmosphere. But I can't stand it any longer. Under the shocked gazes of Lee and the others, Sasuke immediately stepped forward and pried open the two people's clasped hands, then took Naruko's hand and quickly walked towards Ichiraku Ramen shop. Sasuke, why are you hitting me like that? Naruko was confused and looked very angry. Eat ramen, Sasuke said coldly. Eat ramen. Hearing this, Naruko's face changed slightly. Sasuke seemed angry. Suddenly, she became confused. What was going on? That cold Sasuke was actually angry. Gaara looked at his empty palm and was slightly startled. He felt empty in his heart for some reason. Shaoli and the others started to act strange, but Tiantian said, how about we not follow them? She always felt that if she went there again, something might happen. Hearing this, Shaoli and others nodded. Temari and Konkoro looked at the dazed Gaara and stamped their feet anxiously. Catch up with him, why are you still standing here like an idiot? Gaara, If we don't catch up with Naruto, he will be far away. Temari said. Gaara was shocked when he heard that, then he stepped on the sand and chased after Naruko where she left. Sasuke, are you angry? Naruko asked doubtfully. Hearing this, Sasuke ignored the other person and kept pulling him away from the crowded street, but the figure stepping on the sand kept following him like a dog's skin plaster. This made Sasuke very annoyed. What does this Gaara mean? You are just like a dog's skin plaster, why are you following us? Sasuke, what are you doing? Ouch! Naruko tried to shake off the other person's hand, but she couldn't. You're the last one, aren't you worried that the other party is going to kill you? Sasuke said coldly. No, I think he is a nice guy. Hearing this, Mingzi smiled innocently. You'll be sold sooner or later if you keep on like this, and you'll even help others count money with a smile. Sasuke said sarcastically. Are you saying I'm stupid? Are you kidding me? Mingzi was stunned at first, then suddenly became angry, her little face flushed. She is not stupid, not at all. Even teacher Uruka praised her for being smart. This Sasuke is so abominable. He actually called her a fool. What a joke. Is she, Naruto, stupid? She must not be stupid, right? She would never help others count money. At this moment, Sasuke suddenly stopped, and Naruko happened to bump into him from behind, causing her to burst into tears due to the pain. What are you doing? Mingzi pulled the other person's arms apart, covered her red forehead with her hands, and looked very angry. How could he stop just like that? Then, Naruko looked up with some anger, but was stunned to see a ramen restaurant in front of her. This ramen restaurant was the Ichiraku ramen that Naruko had been thinking about day and night. Naruto. And at this moment, Gaara floated over on the sand and slowly appeared next to Naruko and Sasuke. Looking at Gaara, Sasuke's face darkened. This guy is really a dog skin plaster, he can't be shaken off. You said before that you wanted to eat ramen. Gaara said with a hint of longing in his voice. Hehe, let's go together. Hearing this, Naruko smiled and took the two of them into Ichiraku Ramen. Welcome to Ichiraku. Ayame looked at the people that came in, her expression slightly changed, then she looked at Naruko's expression and suddenly felt caring for her. You are, Naruto, so cute. As she said that, Ayame held up Naruto's little face with both hands and started kneading it. Naruto's appearance has really changed. How come he became a girl? After finishing his work, Uncle Ichiraku looked at Naruto, feeling a sense of wonder. Uncle Ichiraku and Sister Ikoris, please stop pinching me. I'm so hungry, Mingzi said dissatisfiedly. Hehe, Naruto is so cute that I can't help myself. His skin is so good, isn't it? Ikoris pinched Naruto's little face, feeling more and more envious. It's so cute, isn't it, Naruko and all, so cute. You look very happy today, Naruto. Uncle Ichiraku said softly as he looked at Naruto. Hey, Naruko rubbed the back of her head. I made a good friend today, I'm so happy. Look, it's Gaara. Naruko opened her body and Gaara and Sasuke came in. Looking at Gaara, they were rarely silent. They had also heard about the former's experience. He had a similar childhood to Naruto, but was even more unfortunate. What do you want to eat? My sister will treat you today, said Ikoris with a smile. Great, I want a big bowl of char siu ramen. No, a super big bowl, Naruko said, dancing excitedly. Gaara, you must try it. Uncle Ichiraku's ramen is delicious. I've been eating it since I was a child. I will never let you down. Naruko turned her head and said to Gaara. The latter nodded and sat down next to Naruko, while Sasuke looked gloomy at being ignored. What's going on? What's wrong with him today? Why does he care so much about that last-placed guy? What does his friendship have to do with me? Gradually, he calmed down, looked at Naruko and Gaara sitting at the table, suddenly turned around, left after saying something. I won't eat it. Sasuke, what's wrong with you? Didn't you tell me before? Naruto looked at Sasuke turning and leaving, and said blankly. It seemed that she didn't provoke him today, right? Ignore me, you idiot. Sasuke said coldly. What, you Sasuke, I asked you kindly but you said this to me, huh, who wants to pay attention to you? Naruko was also successfully angered by the latter's words, turned her head away, and ignored the other party. You are a Tsunere, right? I, Mingzi, will not indulge you, she is serious. Sasuke pulled open the curtain and left the ramen shop. Gaara, you must try it, okay? Naruko asked Gaara, who had been silent beside her. Okay, Gaara nodded. Outside the store, Sasuke clenched his fists and bared his teeth. Can't you ask one more question? Will you die if you ask again? The last one. The more he thought about it, the angrier he became. Finally, Uchiha Sasuke returned to the ramen shop in anger, and the look in his eyes when he stared at Gaara suddenly became dangerous. The latter may have also sensed the dangerous gaze and looked at Sasuke in surprise, with a look of confusion on his face. I don't think I've ever offended the other party. Gaara murmured in his heart, his face full of confusion. Sasuke, don't you want to eat? Looking at Sasuke beside her, Naruko lowered her head and said blankly. I want to eat again, is that not okay? And you, the last one, just ignore me. Sasuke snorted coldly. Hearing this, Mingzi felt even more aggrieved. She clearly hadn't provoked the other party, right? Humph, Sasuke is so abominable. Stupid Sasuke, a huge idiot. After saying this, Naruto ignored the other person anymore. She is serious. Somewhere outside the store, there were two figures hiding in the corner, secretly watching Uzumaki Naruko and the other two. Looking at the scene in the ramen shop, they all couldn't help but smile like aunties. Sister, I feel like Gaara is not doing well. He's too boring. Konkoro looked at Gaara, who had been silent in the store, and said angrily. That Uchiha Sasuke is an enemy. Temari looked at Sasuke and suddenly felt dangerous. This Sasuke must be Gaara's biggest enemy. From that sky curtain, they could know that Naruto could actually say that he was willing to die for him. Too dangerous. Gaara wants to defeat the opponent, but the chances of winning are slim. Since Naruto is so stupid, why don't we trick him into going to the Sand Village? Konkoro suggested. He's the Nine Tails Jinchuriki. It's impossible to think about it, right? Temari said helplessly. What should we do? I think Sasuke has bad intentions. Konkoro said in a serious tone. Sasuke is too dangerous for someone like Gaara, who is not good at communication. This is simply a natural nemesis. Don't worry, Gaara may not lose to that kid. Temari analyzed calmly. Gaara has something that Sasuke doesn't have. Like Naruko, Gaara is the Jinchuriki of the Tailed Beast. With this identity, are you still afraid of Sasuke? And in the other corner, Tiantian and his class also hid in the corner and looked at the scene in the ramen restaurant. It's so interesting, it's so interesting. It would be great if I could record this moment. Tiantian looked at the scene with the same ant-like smile. Why should I come along? Ningji said with a wry smile. He was about to return to Hyuga, but was pulled here by Tenten. Tiantian, why do we have to hide here? Xiao Li was puzzled. What do you two men know? Tiantian complained. When Tiantian looked, he saw Temari and the other two in the corner on the other side. Coincidentally, they were also looking at Tiantian and the others. Suddenly, they all felt a subtle embarrassment. Wow, I met someone of the same mind. One day passed. After Makoto was resurrected, Sasuke was completely different. Although he was still cold and cruel, he was not as cold and heartless as before. Last night, he had a lot to say to Makoto, and that was the happiest day he had had in all these years. But when facing Itachi, he didn't know what expression to use, and the other party was the same. The relationship between the two was extremely subtle. But what bothered Sasuke the most was the matter of Naruko. Ever since Gaara appeared, he found that the other party's position in her heart seemed to be shaken. Especially when he saw the other person sticking to Naruko, he became even more annoyed. This feeling made him very annoyed. Sometimes, he even wanted to fight with the other party. And Gaara just accepted Sasuke's hateful gaze blankly the whole time. He felt confused, as it seemed like he had never offended the other party before. For Gaara, Naruko is his only hope for survival. As for Naruko, she didn't think too much about it, and was even very happy about it, but she was also very distressed. She didn't know why, but Sasuke seemed to suddenly hate Gaara very much. This made Naruko very distressed. Why, isn't it good for us to be friends? Ding, what is inheritance? Upon hearing this, the entire ninja world was stunned. Inheritance, what does it mean? Inheritance, does it mean passing down from one generation to the next? What does it mean? Could it be a clan like the Uchiha that has been passed down from ancient times to the present? Is it the power of inheritance? The inheritance of power. Is it the will that has been passed down from the five great villages? For example, the will of fire or the will of stone. Where the leaves dance, the fire lives on. There are many different opinions in the ninja world about inheritance, but no one can come up with an accurate answer. Even the five major countries have not come up with the most correct answer. What exactly does inheritance mean? Is it just like a shadow? Inheritance, what does inheritance mean? Mingzi asked puzzled. Hearing this, Sasuke and Gaara fell into deep thought, they didn't know either. The sky gradually darkened, and then, there was a forest. A young man holds a sphere that moves irregularly. It is a Rasengan. The person holding the Rasengan is a handsome young man with yellow hair and blue eyes. When I first saw the prototype, I named it. The Nimbus Popsicle inspires Jiraiya's double pill. It's long and smelly. The younger Jiraiya complained helplessly. Looking at that figure, the entire ninja world was shaken. Too familiar, that young man is too familiar, especially Konoha. Then, could that be, the fourth Hokage, Lord Namikaze Minato? The fourth Hokage, oh my god, that's my idol. So handsome. I see, inheritance, the inheritance of the Rasengan, so this is what inheritance means. Yellow Flash, oh my god, my idol. It's unbelievable, is that Minato Namikaze? But why does it give me such a Chunibyo feeling? Land of Lightning, Hidden Cloud Village. Minato Namikaze. The Raikage's face was shocked. Minato Namikaze was the Yellow Flash of the ninja world. In the battle that year, his speed was not worth mentioning in the eyes of the opponent. That man, that super handsome, cool and awesome man. Bakayalu. Even Kurabi's words revealed solemnity. The Iwagaker village was also shocked. They were well aware of the reputation of Minato Namikaze. During the Third Ninja World War, Namikaze Minato used the Flying Thunder God technique to instantly kill dozens of senior ninjas from the Iwagaker village. Since then, Namikaze Minato became famous, and the contemporary Tsuchikage, Onoki, said that whenever he encountered yellow flashes during a mission or on the battlefield, you can drop the mission and run away. That man's reputation back then was so great that even the older generation felt terrified. Unfortunately, he died young in the Nine-Tailed Fox Rebellion. The fourth generation Hokage, Minato Namikaze, my idol. Shao Naruto was very excited. Idol, that was her idol, she wanted to meet him in her life. She grew up listening to each other's stories. During the Nine Tails Rebellion, the fourth Hokage Minato Namikaze sealed the Nine Tails at the risk of his life. He was the hero of Konoha and her idol. Looking at the man in the picture, Naruko giggled excitedly. She was so excited, wasn't she? That was the fourth Hokage. Sasuke and Gaara looked at each other, it was the first time they saw Naruko with such an expression. So silly, but strangely beautiful. Little Anbu, handle it well. In the Hokage's office, it was that day. Jiraiya looked at the scene on the sky and remembered what happened that year. At the same time, he also complained about Minato's weird naming skills. Is that Minato Namikaze, the fourth Hokage after you? Looking at Minato Namikaze in the picture, Uzumaki Mito frowned slightly. Is he also Kushina's lover, Naruto's father? She had heard everything from the monkey, even the Nine Tails Rebellion when Kushina and the fourth Hokage died heroically. Even Naruto is the child of theirs. Being able to use the eight seals, it seems that Kushina has found her own lover. Mito smiled with relief, but it became bitter in the end. Pity. In the end, both of them died young. Lord Mito, although the fourth Hokage and Master Kushina are dead, they still left behind a new fire. Kakashi said. New fire, Naruto. She smiled warmly when she thought of Naruko, the little girl, Naruko, just like Kushina back then, was lively and active. Screen changes. In the deep mountains, Jiraiya and his subordinates appeared, looking ahead with a serious look on their faces. Among his subordinates, one of them is naturally Namikaze Minato. The ones who appeared before them were the Four Tails Jinchuriki Lao Shi and the Five Tails Jinchuriki Han. At this moment, they had already transformed into tailed beasts. The incredibly huge body made Jiraiya and others feel a spiritual fear, and the dark purple-tailed beast jade condensed in their mouths shocked their hearts. That's the tailed beast ball. That scene shocked Minato's mind at the time. In front of such power, ninjas like them were like ants that had no power to tie up a chicken. What is that? What exactly is in that monster's mouth? That's the four-tailed and five-tailed. Facing that kind of power, can humans really contend with that kind of power? The tailed beast Jade, that's the tailed beast Jade. The scene changes again. It was in a forest where people were practicing, on a rock, that was Namikaze Minato, and a young and beautiful girl, the same age as the former. He has gorgeous red hair, is a member of the Uzumaki clan, and is also the Nine Tails Jinchuriki. Who is that? Could it be someone from the Uzumaki clan? Is this, the wife of the fourth Hokage? I seem to have heard before that the fourth Hokage already had a wife, but I didn't expect it to be true. Hehe, Lady Kushina was the one our fourth Hokage loved the most. It's a pity that she also died young. Wow, when the fourth Hokage got married, I was sad for a long time. It was such a happy thing to be able to marry the fourth Hokage. Since this is the wife of the Yondaimi Hokage, do they have any children? I'm curious. I don't know about that either. There shouldn't be a child, right? After all, if there is a child, then we in Konoha should know about it, right? I heard rumors that the Yondaimi Hokage and Lady Kushina had a child. What? The Yondaimi has a child? Unbelievable, I've never heard of it. And how did you know? Actually, I don't know much about it, but a friend of mine worked in the Anbu for a while. He told me this after drinking. Unfortunately, my friend died during his last mission. Among the leaves, the fourth Hokage has a child. Naruko said in shock. The fourth Hokage actually has a child, this is big news. The story that the Sandame grandfather told me didn't mention these things. Even Sasuke was also shocked. What kind of genius was the child of the fourth Hokage? After all, he had heard of the fourth Hokage's fame since he was a child. When I heard my father talk about it back then, I was full of admiration. That is a true genius. If he had a child, and inherited the other party's talent, how abnormal would the child be? In the Hokage's office, humph, Mito couldn't help but snort when she heard this. She couldn't understand what was wrong with announcing the identity of the fourth Hokage's child. Is it because it sounds bad to be spread out, or what? The demon fox has been exposed, so what's wrong with reporting his identity as the son of the fourth Hokage? She was a woman, and it was not good for her not to see her own family members, even those she loved best. If it weren't for the fact that the other party was so old, she really wanted to drag him out and beat him up. This ninjutsu was created to protect you, Minato said softly in the scene. Hey, Kushina was shocked. What on earth is going on? Because we are in the middle of a war, you might be sent to the battlefield someday, so I developed this weapon specifically for fighting against the tailed beasts and enemy Jinchuriki. I can even use ninjutsu that responds to your own chakra, Kushina, and teach it to you. Having said this, Minato paused for a moment, then suddenly turned to Kushina and smiled warmly, saying, because I don't want to lose you. Countless girls in the ninja world looked at this scene and became envious. Oh my, so handsome, isn't he? Is this the fourth Hokage? I love it so much. Is this the charm of the fourth Hokage? The land of water, the hidden mist village. This kind of man is so boring. He is my standard for choosing a partner, but what a pity. Mei Terumi sighed slightly, it was a pity that the other party died too early. In the Hokage's office, a very reliable child, someone worthy of trust. In the office, Mito nodded with satisfaction. She was still worried that Kushina was not living well. Among the leaves, so cool, I want to be like this in the future. Naruto's eyes were bubbling with excitement, isn't he so handsome? Gaara keenly heard a different meaning. Did the other party also want to be said that? Gaara somehow put himself in Minato's shoes, while Naruko put himself in Kushina's shoes. Naruto, we're friends, so I don't want to lose you. Gaara said. Hearing this, Mingzi was slightly stunned and looked at the other person with great emotion. She was so moved that she almost cried. It's really great to have Gaara as a friend. Sasuke looked at all this with a gloomy face, wanting to say something but stopping himself. In the end, he could only swallow the words in frustration. What a shame, such a gentle man ended up dying tragically in the Nine-Tailed Fox Rebellion. God is jealous of his talent. I remember that when the four great Hokage passed away, they seemed to be quite young. Alas, it is really the case that the gods are jealous of their talents. The Nine-Tails Rebellion. Why was Konoha suddenly attacked by the Nine Tails? Who was the previous Nine Tails Jinchuriki? Who knows? We are just civilians, what can we know? I'm afraid that only the top leaders of the five major ninja villages know about the previous Nine Tails Jinchuriki. It is of great significance, so I don't need to explain it. Why bother with all this? Who knows if the sky curtain will be exposed in the future? Just watch it with peace of mind. On screen, Kushina was stunned by Minato's sudden confession, and then, an evil chakra spread out from her body, and her originally beautiful pupils instantly turned into scarlet vertical pupils. Ah, Kushina held her head and groaned in pain. And behind her, a scarlet tail suddenly grew out, in the form of a chakra tail. The ninja world was stunned when they saw this scene, their eyes full of shock and dullness. They were very familiar with this look. Wasn't this the mode that Naruto had used in the scene during the previous battle at the Valley of the End? In other words, the other party was actually a Jinchuriki who possessed a tailed beast, and there was only one tailed beast in Konoha, the Nine Tails. The previous Jinchuriki, the Yondaime's wife, is actually a Jinchuriki. Unbelievable, the Nine Tails Jinchuriki. Oh my god, this looks just like Naruto before, and with this evil chakra, I feel scared even through the screen. Oh my god, I remember now. Didn't you say before that the fourth Hokage and his wife had a child? Go upstairs, what do you want to say? This person in the picture has red hair. She is from the Uzumaki clan. Her last name is Uzumaki. Uzumaki. Whirlpool, what do you want to say, brother? Why can't I understand you? No, are you a little bit stupid? Can't you guess what I said? Naruto's last name is Uzumaki. Uzumaki, Uzumaki Naruto, the Nine Tails Jinchuriki, the fourth Hokage. Holy crap. No way, no way, it can't be what I guessed, right? Am I mistaken? Is this guess a little too shocking? Among the leaves, that was the Nara family. Shikamaru frowned and thought about it. In the picture, there is Kushina Uzumaki, the Nine Tails Jinchuriki, the fourth Hokage, and his yellow hair. Nine-tailed Jinchuriki, yellow hair. Naruto, thinking of this possibility, Shikamaru suddenly opened his eyes full of shock and disbelief. He murmured, Naruto, is he the son of the fourth Hokage? This news was too shocking. Even Shikamaru found it hard to accept it for a while. Naruto was suspected to be the child of the fourth Hokage and his wife. This is so shocking, he is the fourth generation. But, Shikamaru couldn't help but worry about Naruto's condition at this moment. If he knew that his biological father was the fourth Hokage he admired. Thinking of what happened to the old man all those years ago, he sighed. The 12 ninjas, except for some careless ninja like Shaoli, basically guessed this possibility, and they felt a mixture of absurdity and shock for a moment. Worse still, Ino went to ask her parents directly, but the response she got was silence. Naruto. Naruto is the son of the fourth Hokage. Sakura murmured, not daring to believe this speculation, because that was the fourth Hokage, the child of the four great Hokages. Such a powerful and handsome fourth generation, children and so on. No way, no way, this must be a mistake, otherwise, how could Naruto, the child of the fourth Hokage, be persecuted and even ostracized like that? The Hokage's son is being ostracized. How is that possible? But on second thought, she fell silent again, because isn't Gaara, the child of the fourth Kage Rasa, a typical example? What are they talking about? Why did they mention me? Mingzi asked in confusion. Why did they mention her for no reason? Sasuke and Gaara fell silent, especially the former, who looked at Naruko with shock and complexity. Looking at the other person's confused expression, Sasuke gave up the idea of telling her the fact he had guessed. If that were the case, could she really accept being alone all the time? Being ostracized by the people around her, she suddenly told her one day that her father was a beloved hero in the Hokage. As a hero's child, she was called a fox demon and a monster. Gaara tried to speak but was stopped by Sasuke. The former looked at him blankly but the latter just shook his head at him. The five major countries were also shocked, but they were also skeptical about this speculation. After all, it was just a guess. But they might as well attract attention. The scene changes, that is Kushina's inner world, that is a huge nine-tailed fox, tied in a huge ball of flames. I've already told you not to trust anyone. This guy is also using you. Kyuubi bewitched Kushina, seeming to want to shake her. Remove this seal quickly, so you can be free from the pain, Ninetales said grimly. In the picture, Kushina looked at the other person in fear. If you don't want to do it, I will possess you and kill you. The nine scarlet tails of the nine-tailed fox are swinging wildly in the air, as if attacking the opponent. At this moment, Kyuubi's movements suddenly froze, and a sealing technique quickly formed in front of him. Kushina, hold on. That is the outside world. Namikaze Minato drags his tired body and hugs the frantic Kushina. He presses his palm on her abdomen and performs a sealing technique. Kyuubi was very shocked by the opponent's method, and was also puzzled. Why, a ninja like you, why would you be restrained by this little girl? I like strong people, people who are stronger than me. So, I like Kushina very much. I can't bear losing her. Not only Kushina in the picture, but even the ninja world was deeply moved by Minato's words. This is the charm of the fourth Hokage. The yellow flash of that year was the most dazzling existence back then. The man who ended the third ninja world war. Wow, why do you let a single person like me watch this? I'm going to cry to death. Namikaze Minato, the fourth Hokage, wow, so handsome, isn't he? You little fourth Hokage, your looks are not even 1/10,000th of mine. I was thinking, there is no Baizetsu here, right? Too handsome, even a man like me feels a little moved when seeing him, is this the charm of the fourth Hokage? This kind of man is so boring, isn't he? My idol. This is just hot. I can't bear it anymore. I can't bear it anymore. Netizens up there in Kumogakure, calm down. This is the sky curtain. That's the fourth Hokage. You are so envious of Kushina, right? How can she be admired by the fourth Hokage's idol? Why doesn't the fourth Hokage like me? Madam up there, please calm down too. Even Sakura and Ino could not deny that the fourth Hokage was simply too gentle and so handsome. He looks even more handsome than Sasuke. This kind of man is too boring, okay. So cool, I will definitely become someone like the fourth Hokage in the future. No, I will surpass the fourth Hokage and become a Hokage who is even more handsome and powerful than him. Naruko shouted excitedly. Looking at this scene, Sasuke felt more and more complicated. When the other party knew the truth, would he collapse like him? Want to surpass the fourth Hokage? You, but the second pillar was still tough, mocking him without disguising it. In the end, he softened and said, but, you only have a slight chance of surpassing him. How could there be only a little bit? I can do it, Mingzi said unconvinced. You can do it, I believe you. Gaara said softly. Hehe. Gaara, do you also believe that I can become a Hokage who surpasses the fourth Hokage? I'm so happy. Naruko chuckled, and the look of her giggle made the latter stunned unconsciously. Sasuke's face darkened. In the scene, Kushina was reminded of the conversation between her and Mito when they were children because of Minato's words. Kushina, we may indeed be at the center of the vortex, but if you take the initiative to climb, we will definitely be able to find love. Find someone who is worthy of trust and love. If that happens, the whirlpool will eventually become a spiral. Kushina didn't understand what that meant when she was a child, but now, when she sees Minato again and sees his appearance. Suddenly, Kushina opened her eyes, and in an instant, golden chains burst out from her body, instantly restraining the nine tails' movements. Even I would resist. It's confirmed. It's confirmed. I now declare that the matter concerning Uzumaki Naruto is confirmed. Uzumaki Naruto, he's actually their child, he's actually the Yondaime Hokage's child. That catchphrase, no, is that his mother's catchphrase. Unbelievable, ha 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 ha, now it's going to be interesting, Naruto could actually be their child. I can already imagine the expressions of the villagers of Konoha. It must be very funny, right? Hehe, I can only say that they really deserve to die. The entire Konoha was shocked, especially the villagers of Konoha, who were looking at the sky with disbelief. What did they hear? That demon fox, could he be the child of the fourth Hokage? Are you kidding? Are you kidding me? This must be fake, how is it possible? Isn't he a demon fox? It must be fake, right? How is this possible? What a joke, if it's true, then we were wrong about him before. It's fake. Fake, all of this is fake. How could that demon fox be the child of the fourth Hokage? Hokage-sama, please say something, tell us quickly, this is fake, right? It must be like this. I don't believe it, I don't believe it. In the Hokage's office. Hearing these vicious words, Uzumaki Mito suddenly turned his gaze towards the other party and said coldly, Sarutobi Hiruzen. Upon hearing this, Sarutobi Hiruzen smiled bitterly and immediately sent Shikaku to reveal the truth that had been buried for 12 years. When the villagers of Konoha learned that this was actually true, they were all stunned. When the 12 young warriors heard the news, although they had some guesses before, they were still shocked. I am the child of the fourth Hokage. In Konoha, upon hearing the news, Naruko was completely stunned, like a wooden chicken, with no movement on her face. She is the child of the fourth Hokage, the child of that man. No, how could she be the other party's child? Why would she be the other party's child? The third generation grandfather said that her parents died in the Nine Tail Rebellion. Yes, they died. So those who died were my parents. She didn't know what expression to show. The truth shocked her and frightened her, yes, she was frightened. How could she be the other party's child? Wasn't she an orphan? She had always been a fox demon. Wasn't she a monster that no one wanted? Her state of mind has undergone a huge change. Naruto, Sasuke and Gaara murmured in complicated voices. This can't be true, it must not be true. Mingzi's face was pale, without a trace of blood at the moment, and she said tremblingly. The two were silent, their eyes full of heartache. Sasuke, tell me, this isn't true, right? This isn't true, right? Naruko grabbed his shoulders, her eyes filled with panic and a hint of anticipation. She wanted to hear the answer. She wasn't, she definitely wasn't. There must be a mistake, how could she be, their child? Yes, you are their child. Sasuke sighed and said with unprecedented tenderness in his voice. Naruko was stunned. Her world collapsed the moment Sasuke finished speaking. The person she had always admired, the person she wanted to surpass. Her idol. It turned out that it was her biological father, his father, who sealed the Nine Tails in her body with his own hands. The fourth Hokage is my father. The Nine Tails Rebellion, the eyes of rejection and hatred in Konoha, after the truth came to light. Roar! That was the huge Nine Tails chakra that instantly burst out from Naruko's body, and the huge evil aura instantly blew away the two people closest to Naruko. That Ludo! Sasuke shouted anxiously, and Gaara directly summoned sand, trying to get close to the opponent, but the evil chakra made him completely helpless. Wah! Anger and tears filled Naruko's eyes. In an instant, three nine-tailed chakra tails swayed in the air. And the fourth one also gushed out at a speed visible to the naked eye. She was so angry. This truth felt fake to her. What was the truth? What was right? Who should she believe? The flower of hope, after the truth was revealed, was gradually stained with a touch of black. The people she admires the most, the people she wants to surpass, the people she loves. Now tell her that they are her parents. Was it her biological father who sealed the nine-tailed fox in her and caused her to live a lonely past? Was it her biological father? Wah! The fourth scarlet tail slowly grew out, and her pretty face began to become ferocious, with a violent and evil aura that madly permeated the area. The overwhelming anger almost enveloped the entire Konoha. Naruto, Sasuke and Gaara were extremely anxious, the former even opened his Sharingan. He could feel how much pain the other party was in. Naruko was already engulfed by anger and could no longer hear any sound. Was the truth false? Her father was the fourth Hokage. Then why did they seal the nine-tailed fox in me? Why did they do this? She is only 12 now, and she doesn't have the courage and determination of a 16-year-old. She will also go crazy. At this moment, several figures rushed over from the Hokage's office, and the beautiful figure immediately waved her hand. King Kong blockade. Golden chains shot out from his sleeves and wrapped around Naruko, who was gradually transforming into a tailed beast. For a moment, he suppressed her and prevented the fourth tail from growing any further. Naruto, Sasuke and the other man wanted to rush over, but were stopped by Kakashi who came rushing over. Sasuke glared at the other party in dissatisfaction. Kakashi, what are you doing? This is not something you can solve. It's safest to stay here. Kakashi said in a deep voice. Sarutobi Hiruzen looked at this scene and felt more and more ashamed. The result of all this was that he had never told the other party about her parents because he was afraid that she would know. What terrible things will she do? He hopes that he will tell her everything when she becomes a mentally strong and mature ninja. But, bang, 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 those were the three tails behind Naruko, which were completely rioting at this moment, frantically destroying the surrounding buildings, causing Mito's King Kong blockade to shake slightly. The technique of messing up the lion's hair. Jiraiya's hair began to grow dense, and suddenly shot out, tugging at the three tails on Naruko's back. Lord Mito, please, Jiraiya roared. It was difficult even for him to restrain the furious Naruko. Mito nodded, then moved her body and instantly came in front of Naruko, but the diamond chain in her sleeves did not move at all, tightly wrapping around her. Looking at the other person's beast-like face, especially the eyes, tears have already flowed down at this moment, and the vertical pupils are full of confusion, helplessness, fear. Mito felt a slight pain in his heart, raised his hand and gently pressed the other person's forehead, and a soft light slowly seeped out. "Let me see, Kyuubi," she murmured, her eyes closed, as if to join Naruko's inner depths. "Naruto, Naruto-kun," those were the 12 little warriors. After feeling the overwhelming chakra, they also rushed over. Looking at the scene in front of them, Sakura and the others covered their mouths in disbelief. "Naruto-kun," Hinata covered her red lips, her eyes full of heartache. Not only that, there were groups of villagers who rushed over after seeing the changes here. Looking at this scene, they looked extremely stunned and complicated. "Don't go over there, stay here," Kakashi and Jiraiya roared. Boom. At this moment, when Mito tried to enter Naruko's inner world, he was suddenly bounced away by an unknown force, which shocked the latter. 8 Trigrams Seal. With a slightly focused look in her eyes, she lifted up the man's clothes, revealing the seal on his lower abdomen. The 8 Trigrams Seal is very strong, powerful enough to block anyone who covets the 9 tails, but at the same time, this powerful sealing technique also prevents Mito from entering the other person's inner world. Even Mito had a solemn look at this moment. She didn't have the key to this Bagua seal, so she couldn't unlock it. Even though she was the eldest princess of the Uzumaki clan, she didn't have that kind of means. "Unless, you are Hashirama Senju. What is that? Is that a monster? What a monster. That's the child of the fourth Hokage. What did I do before? I actually rejected the son of the Hokage. I'm so mad. Monster, that's a monster. The son of the fourth generation has turned into a monster. What should I do? What should I do?" Upon hearing this, Uzumaki Mito's pretty face was filled with anger, and she shouted fiercely, "Shut up." It was a chakra that was not inferior to the 9 tails at the moment. It suddenly burst out, and the ground in this area suddenly cracked. The villagers shut up instantly, not daring to make any sound. "Call out." That was Itachi, who came over with Uchiha Makoto. She also looked distressed when she saw the changes in Naruko. "Is this the 9 tails chakra?" Itachi asked solemnly. "Inner world, what should I believe? Someone come save me." Mingzi knelt in the water in pain. At this moment, the water in the sewer also began to accumulate. She was in so much pain and confusion. Behind a huge sealed door, there was the 9-tailed fox, which showed its sharp fangs and beckoned, "Give me your body. I will set you free. Take your body, take everything you have." One of Naruko's eyes began to turn scarlet. It wasn't a vertical pupil, but scarlet. Her face began to become dull, and she walked forward blankly. Bang, bang, that was the fourth one, which suddenly shot out at this moment. It was not over yet. That was the fifth one, which also spread out at the same moment the fourth one shot out. Outside, Sasuke stared at the three Magatama Sharingan, feeling more anxious than anyone else. "I can definitely do something, I can definitely do it. I can feel that feeling. I can feel the feeling of being the last in line." Gaara waved his hand and summoned the sand in the gourd to grab the fifth tail that had not yet grown, giving Mito time to think. And the fourth one was caught by Sarutobi Hiruzen. "Lord Mito, do you need me to use some illusion?" Itachi asked. "No, if we use illusion, it will cause a huge burden to Naruto," Mito analyzed calmly. Ah, it was Naruko's skin on the surface that began to tear apart, revealing the bloody skin underneath. Her originally delicate face now looked quite hideous. "Naruto," Makoto's expression changed slightly, and her heart also felt like it was burning. Has it already started transforming into the Nine Tails? Mito witnessed it, feeling increasingly solemn. If this continues, Mingzi might be in danger. Boom. The fifth tail completely broke free from its restraints. Gaara's eyes focused and he waved his hands. A vast amount of dust burst out of the gourd, almost suppressing the evil tail. But the Nine Tails' repulsion was equally terrifying, and Gaara couldn't hold onto it several times. The 12 little strongmen and others were very worried, but they did not dare to move forward casually, because Mingzi's change at this moment was too frightening. It's just like a small nine-tailed fox. Naruto, you said, you wanted to be Hokage, and you wanted to be more handsome than the Yondaime. You said it, Naruto. Gaara restrained the tail and shouted at the rioting Naruto. Gaara's words made the originally agitated Naruko pause slightly. It was during this pause that Mito's eyes suddenly focused. He quickly formed a seal and pressed down the Bagua seal on his abdomen with one palm. Open. The Bagua seal was loosened by Mito's pressure, but it was not over yet. The five major chakras flowed between Mito's fingers. What does Lord Mito want to do? Looking at Mito's actions, Jiraiya was suddenly shocked. What kind of method was that? In the absence of a key, how could the seal of the eight diagrams be loosened? It was conceivable how powerful this grandmother of the Uzumaki clan, the eldest princess, was. The eight trigrams seal is loosened. Could it be that she is planning to help Naruto break the seal? If so, wouldn't that be possible? Jiraiya muttered in horror. Untie. Mito groaned softly, and a hole suddenly appeared above the Bagua seal. The original sealing technique began to waver, as if it would collapse at any time. However, this phenomenon was stabilized by Mito's sealing technique. Then, Mito closed his eyes and tried to enter the other person's inner world again, but it was still useless. Her heart is now closed. What should she do? What should she do? I can't enter her inner world. Mito closed her eyes and bit her red lips. Upon hearing this, Jiraiya and others turned pale. Could it be that even the other party was unable to do it? Hinata and the others turned pale, looking unbelievable. Could it be that Naruto-kun really? Is there no hope? Sasuke stared at the scene in shock, as if he was making a huge decision. I can do something, I can definitely do something. Her anger, her mood. Sasuke gritted his teeth and glared with his Sharingan. The next moment, he broke through Kakashi's protection and walked towards the position of Uzumaki Mito and Naruko. Sasuke, Makoto and the others were startled. What was the other party doing running over now? Lord Mito, let me try. Sasuke said in a deep voice. Mito looked at him in surprise, then nodded and said, concentrate your chakra and see if you can connect it to Naruto's chakra. Hearing this, Sasuke nodded and quickly did as he was told. It was light blue chakra, and as soon as it appeared, it instantly connected with Naruko's chakra. Successful, Mito was very surprised. Even Mito, who was a member of the same clan, would find it difficult to achieve an instant connection, right? Who is this kid? Sasuke did not respond, but closed his eyes. Gradually, the noise around him disappeared, and his consciousness began to become hazy. At this moment, under the connection of chakra, Sasuke saw many of Naruto's past memories, which were never seen by Tianmu. Why? Why does everyone hate me? Why do you treat me like this? Who are my parents? Why don't they want me anymore? Where are they? Ramen is the most delicious thing. Hehe, I will go to Ichiraku Ramen every day. To the world, what does a tiny person like me mean? I am who I am. I am Uzumaki Naruto. The fourth Hokage is my favorite hero, so I aspire to surpass him and become a Hokage who is even more handsome than him. Why, my father is the fourth Hokage. Then what does all my past mean? And why would he seal the Nine Tails into me, a child? It's the world's fault. The overwhelming memories almost overwhelmed Sasuke's consciousness. In this memory, he saw Naruto hugging his knees and crying in pain in the middle of the night. That was something Sasuke had never seen before, that last place guy, who always looked funny with a silly smile. That's in front of the Nine Tail Gate. Naruko was stunned, her eyes were full of scarlet color, and had long been stagnant. The water around her was constantly surging and expanding. My father is the fourth Hokage. He is my dad. She is moving forward slowly, and is about to reach the gate. That's it. Unlock this seal. Come quickly. Bring your emotions, bring your everything. Give me your heart. The nine-tailed fox inside the gate bared its fangs, bewitching the other party. The water slowly lifted Naruko up and fixed her on a seal. She slowly stretched out her hand. Naruto, you said, you wanted to be Hokage, and you wanted to be more handsome than the fourth Hokage. You said it, right? Naruto, that was Gaara's cry, appearing deep in her heart, causing Naruko to be stunned, and her outstretched hand stopped in midair. Hokage, outside, there was a man who appeared in front of Naruko regardless of the danger. He looked at Naruko and tears flowed down his face. His eyes were full of pain and self-blame. You are an excellent student recognized by me, so you can't fall here, you have to survive, teacher, but I haven't seen the day when you become Hokage yet. Uruka's roaring voice rushed straight into Naruko's heart. Uruka, teacher, Naruko calmed down, and a trace of clarity returned to her eyes. He is an excellent student whom I recognize. He is no longer a demon fox, but, from the Hidden Leaf Village. Uzumaki Naruto, you idiot, you're the last one. It was a hand that suddenly pulled Naruko down from midair, and immediately, Naruko regained her clarity of mind. Looking closely, isn't this Uchiha Sasuke? At this moment, the other party's mouth is full of rough breath. At this moment, Sasuke's face looked terrifyingly ferocious. On the sky screen, the nine tails opened its huge mouth, and a black-tailed beast ball condensed in its mouth, containing a terrifying power. And Kushina outside, seemed to have heard Minato's cry and regained consciousness, but the next moment, Kushina suddenly groaned in pain. You, a huge idiot. That was Sasuke's voice, which reached Naruko's heart. At that moment, a not-so-large hand directly pulled Naruko down from midair. Naruko snapped back to her senses, and the person who appeared in front of her was none other than Uchiha Sasuke. Sasuke, why are you here? Naruko murmured with tears still in her eyes. Looking at the girl like this, Sasuke felt a slight pain in his heart. He didn't know why, but seeing her like this, he also felt very sad. We are the last one. Before Sasuke could finish his words, Naruko's mind began to blur again, and scarlet blood covered her once blue eyes. Wow, ah, that's it, release all your hatred. Give me everything you have. The voice of the Nine Tails still lingered in Naruko's ears, as if bewitching her mind. Naruto, Sasuke's face changed, and then he looked at the huge door behind Naruto. He realized that it was a demon fox like Mount Tai. Those Nine Tails and that posture made Sasuke feel palpitated and shocked. Is that, the nine-tailed fox in Naruto's body? Sasuke stared with his Sharingan, feeling the overwhelming pressure, his heart pounding with fear. Uchiha kid, I am surprised that you can appear here, hehe. Ninetales said grimly as he looked at the tiny Sasuke below. Wow, at this moment, Naruko suddenly hissed, the hissing sound became more and more intense, and the four tails swayed behind him. Sasuke hurried forward to check the changes of the opponent. Naruto, you, but at this time, on the sky screen. Puff. Minato's eyes suddenly shrank. It was a hand that pierced through his chest, and the one who pierced through him was Kushina in the form of a tailed beast. Sealed space. Puff. Naruko's tailed beast-like palm also pierced through Sasuke's chest, causing the latter's pupils to shrink slightly. The pain made Sasuke wail. Outside, Sasuke's face also turned pale, causing everyone to pause slightly, and then his eyes were tightly closed. That was scarlet blood, which began to flow out slowly. This little guy's chakra changes. Mito was shocked. Sasuke's chakra suddenly began to surge. What on earth is it? That is, could that be? Itachi looked at this scene and immediately opened his Mangekyo Sharingan. Naruto, wake up quickly. Uruka tightly grasped the other's tailed beast hand and cried out in pain. He is so useless that he can't even save his own students. He said he treated the other person as his own brother, but in the end he didn't even have a way to save him. Naruto, the other 12 wanted to rush over, but were stopped by Kakashi. Naruto, Sasuke, Makoto clenched her hands tightly. She was extremely worried about the two of them. If Itachi hadn't stopped her, she would have rushed over long ago. In the sealed space, Sasuke tightly grasped the other's wrist, spitting out a large amount of blood from his mouth. The pain made him shrink his eyes slightly, but he still gritted his teeth and said firmly, I won't leave. I will never leave. I saw it in your heart. Kyuubi was puzzled. This scene was somehow so familiar. It seemed that someone had done the same thing before. Why are you so persistent? What does this guy mean to you? Kyuubi asked. What on earth does this guy have that would make you do this? It's a friend, Sasuke shouted. You are the one I admire. Those were the words Naruto said to Sasuke in the golden space before. It's not like that. It's not like that. Actually, it's me. I had nothing at that time, and you have been alone since then, just like me, the only one left in the Uchiha clan, and you are out of tune with the people in the village. The reason you did those pranks was to attract the attention of the villagers. You wanted to establish some kind of relationship with them in this way. At first I thought you were a boring guy and a mischievous coward. But, seeing you doing those stupid things and being criticized, I don't know why, I gradually became interested in you. At that time, I thought that your weakness infected me. After that, every time I saw you, this feeling became stronger and stronger, and I gradually cared more about you. Seeing you trying so hard to build relationships with people around you, I can't help but think of my family. I don't know why, but I feel relieved. I think you feel the same way. Ah, Sasuke roared in pain, a burning pain spread in his chest, but he still held the other tightly. But, I also felt that this was a kind of weakness. In order to get rid of this weakness, I devoted myself to cultivation, hoping to use it to motivate myself, and also to avenge my brother, to surpass him. But you and I were assigned to the same class. When I'm with you, I gradually remember the feelings of my family. You who shouted loudly that you wanted to become Hokage, completed the mission together, and felt each other getting stronger. I gradually had the idea of fighting with you. Gradually, I felt like a family in Class 7. Whenever I see you in pain, yes. I feel heartbroken, too. I want to be like you, just as handsome, just as powerful, and always chase after you. You are the one I admire. Quite the opposite. Actually, I envy you. Wow. Sasuke spat out a mouthful of blood, tears glistening in his eyes for some reason. He stared at Naruto who had transformed into the Four Tails, his voice becoming hoarse as he said, You who aim to be the Hokage, you who regard me as a friend. Keep your word and do what you say. Isn't this your way of ninja? Naruto, in your heart, I won't leave. I definitely won't leave. In Kushina's heart, I can feel it, in Kushina's heart. I have always existed, in an area of Konoha. There were countless people gathered, and they looked at the center, where Naruto was restrained by many powerful ninjas, and they were immediately terrified and shocked. But the woman with long red hair seemed extremely familiar, yet strange to them. That's Uchiha Itachi. Why is he in Konoha village? What's going on? Why did Uchiha Itachi appear in Konoha? Then, could that be? Mido-sama, that's the first generation mistress, Mido-sama. What happened? Wasn't Mido-sama already dead back then? Why does he still exist? The villagers began to panic and the noisy noises began again. You bunch of idiots, shut up. Jiraiya yelled, instantly stopping all the villagers. Everyone shut their mouths silently. Uzumaki Mido closed her eyes tightly. With her strong perception, she felt that in Sasuke's eyes, there was a powerful force that was spreading. That kind of power, is like, opening your eyes. At such an age, Mido sighed softly. Uchiha Itachi, on the other hand, was full of worries. The earlier he opened his eyes, the more damage to his body would be difficult to estimate, just like him. He knew very well that he would not live long, and the sequelae of the Mangekyo Sharingan had made him live in agony over the years. So, Sasuke, sealed space, keep your word and do what you say. Isn't this your way of ninja? Sasuke looked at the other person, held the other person's hand tightly, stared at the other person's scarlet cheek, and said, These vows, your dreams, the things you said, doesn't it all matter? Are you really going to forget? Naruto, the three Magatamas slowly rotate in the eyes, changing. Final, those pupils were like six-pointed stars, emitting a scarlet and dazzling brilliance in the sealed space. Naruko, who had transformed into the Four Tails, was stunned, and a memory suddenly appeared in her mind. I'm here, my name is Uzumaki Naruto. My favorite food is ramen, and my favorite is Ichiraku ramen that Aruka-sensei treated me to. What I hate is waiting for 3 minutes for instant noodles. My dream is, to surpass the Hokage. Let everyone in the village recognize my existence. That was on the rooftop. That was the dream the boy expressed when he first became a ninja. His dream, the existence he always wanted to become, the Hokage he admired. He wants to surpass the Hokage. Become a Hokage who is more handsome and powerful than the fourth Hokage. Keep your word and do what you say, this is my way of ninja. Instantly, the four tails dissipated, and all the evil aura and violent chakra disappeared, revealing Naruko's original appearance. Her eyes still have tears. Awake, Kyuubi narrowed his eyes in confusion, then looked at Sasuke and was suddenly startled. That was kaleidoscope, outside world. Wow, the evil chakra aura dissipated completely, Naruko's body returned to its original state, and the five tails also dissipated. Successful. Everyone was overjoyed. Uruka and the others had already burst into tears, and their worries were finally put at ease. That's great, Naruto-kun is okay. It's really great. Hinata cried excitedly. Similarly, Sakura, a member of Team 7, also cried. Naruto is a guy that's too worrying, isn't he? Said Inazuka Kiba. After all, it's inevitable that she would become like this after encountering such a thing. However, we didn't expect that her parents would be the fourth Hokage. Shino said. Huh, Naruto is fine. Shikamaru's team also breathed a sigh of relief. Why haven't you woken up yet? Mito asked in a serious tone, his heart still hanging. The Nine Tails chakra had indeed disappeared, and the other party should have woken up, but what was going on with this strange feeling? Mito thought solemnly. Sealed space. Sasuke. Looking at the boy so close, Mingzi was slightly stunned, her delicate little face looked extremely dull, but the next moment, her pupils suddenly shrank. There was a big hole in the other person's chest, and her hand pierced through the other person. She was stunned, her eyes full of horror and disbelief. What are you looking at? Sasuke muttered in pain, and Naruko hurriedly pulled her hand carefully away from the other's chest. Wow, as Sasuke wailed in pain, it was hard to imagine how painful it was to have his chest pierced. What's wrong, Sasuke, don't scare me. Naruko was so panicked that she was about to cry, and tears flowed again. Sasuke, please don't die. Hearing this, Sasuke's face darkened. You are the one who is going to die. Can you please stop talking, you loser? Okay, Mingzi shut up aggrievedly. Sasuke began to take a deep breath, and the Mangekyo radiated a strange light in the sealed space. For some reason, the big hole in his chest was slowly repairing. If it were in the outside world, it would basically be impossible to appear, but fortunately, this is Naruko's consciousness space, or the Nine Tails sealed space. As long as his consciousness is strong, he won't be able to withstand much harm. Looking at Sasuke, Naruko felt at ease for some reason. Even though she was in the Nine Tails space, she no longer felt afraid. Sasuke felt a little uncomfortable being stared at by Naruko, but because he had just opened his eyes, his face was unusually pale, almost bloodless. It's time to go back. Sasuke said softly. Hearing this, Mingzi nodded her head like a little chicken, then she became confused again and tilted her head and said naively, but, how do I get back? Hearing this, Sasuke was speechless, he didn't know either. Hehe, this is so interesting. This is so interesting. That was the nine-tailed fox's eerie voice, echoing in the sealed space. Suddenly, the two sides became tense. Do you know how the previous generation of the Nine Tails Jinchuriki died? The Nine Tails looked at Naruko and said. Upon hearing this, Mingzi suddenly tensed up, having an inexplicable bad feeling. She was stabbed to death by me, with my sharp claws. Your parents were killed by me. Naruko's eyes suddenly turned scarlet again. I am going to kill you. Naruto. Sasuke gripped the other's shoulders, and Naruko finally calmed down, but her eyes were filled with murderous intent. After this incident, she is no longer the pure Naruko. I hope everyone will support it and subscribe more.